Stadium in Austin, looking to begin another win streak on their home turf. Tonight from Austin, Texas, college football on TBS Superstation. Part of Big PlayStation Saturday kicks off now.
Texas football, a history of stars. Winning. Tradition. But stars and tradition alone don't win championships. Always among the country's elite, key losses in recent years have kept the Longhorns from conquering the Big 12 and the college football world. Tonight, Texas continues its quest for college football's ultimate prize, for present glory on the Superstation.
The last time Texas played in Austin, their 20-game home win streak came to an end. Tonight, before a sellout crowd of over 80,000 and some pretty good-looking barbecue, they look to begin another streak. Tonight, they play host to the green wave of Tulane in a very high-powered offense.
Hello again, everybody. Along with Charles Davis, I'm Ron Thula. Now, Charles, after that loss to Arkansas, Texas wide receiver Roy Williams said, "I'm personally offended." He then went on to challenge his team by telling everybody else, "We're going to run the table." Pretty bold challenge, but he could probably back it up.
Very Joe Namath-esque, I would say. But he is a guy who has the talent to back it up. Roy Williams, one of the top players in the country, would have been one of the top draft choices last year had he chosen to come out, but honored his commitment to Texas and came back for his senior year, and they're so glad to have him. 37 consecutive games with a reception. He is their big play guy, and he's obviously their leader. Where he goes, they will follow. But the big question mark tonight is for Texas is defense. What are they going to do on that side of the ball? They haven't been challenged very much in the passing game thus far, but a lot of running and option teams. They're rated first in the country, but they will be tested. And one guy in particular, their all-star linebacker, Derek Johnson. This is a guy with a ton of talent. He'll be spying on Tulane's top running back tonight, Mwelde Moore, and also keeping an eye on J.P. Lossman, their quarterback. He has a big task ahead of him.
Well, you talk about a great offense. Defensive coordinator of Texas, Carl Reese, calls the Tulane offense basketball on grass. Pretty good description. It's similar to Texas Tech, of course, who beat Texas last year, and their quarterback, J.P. Lossman, has some similarities to Cliff Kingsbury, former Texas Tech Red Raider.
He does. He knows how to move the ball around and get it to a lot of receivers, but he has a bigger arm so he can go deep. J.P. Lossman is one of the top quarterbacks in the country, and you should enjoy watching him tonight. He will throw it deep, will lose his speedy wide receivers, but he has a ton of talent and also a lot of confidence. The top-rated quarterback in the country in terms of touchdown passes and yardage, and he also has a great guy in the backfield, a guy by the name of Mwelde Moore. This running back is one of the top ones in the country, one of three guys who's run for 1,000 yards the last 2 years, and is the all-time leading rusher in Conference USA. And besides that, he's also the leading pass receiver for the Tulane Green Wave. Both of these guys will make a difference in tonight's game.
But how do you slow J.P. Lossman down? You have to get to him, but how?
You have to get to him from a variety of angles, have to bring a lot of different blitzes, different stunts, and sometimes you don't rush him at all, just make him hold the football. Carl Reese, the defensive coordinator from Texas, wants to get a lot of hits on J.P. Lossman and hopefully reduce his productivity, because his fourth quarters have been out of this world. 74% passing, 9 touchdowns, only 1 interception thus far. We'll see how it goes tonight.
If you like offense, do not go anywhere. There's going to be a lot of points scored tonight. Before the opening kickoff, let's send it back to our studios in Atlanta with Ernie Johnson and Ryan Buck.
And a beautiful day in Austin, Texas today. And just a couple of moments ago, one of the great scenes, the Longhorns coming out of the tunnel with the smoke. 80,000 plus, the sellout crowd standing on their feet. How do you combat that in an excellent Texas Longhorn team? Our Craig Sager is standing by with Tulane head coach Chris Selfo. Sags?
Well, it's a major challenge for the Tulane coaching staff and the players. What has to happen for you guys to pull the upset today?
Well, we've got to get some help from them. We've got to play nearly a flawless game to have a chance. You know, it's going to be an emotional deal early in the game. That's going to wear off. Our kids got to keep their composure and make something happen all three phases today.
What would a flawless game entail?
No turnovers, no penalties. Every time we got an opportunity to make a play, make it.
All right, thanks a lot. Ron, Charles?
All right, Craig. Chris Selfo is going to be 40 years old on Tuesday. What a great birthday present this would be. Mack Brown in his 6th year, 20th year overall as a head coach. No coach in UT history, not even Daryl Royal, has won 9 games in 5 consecutive seasons or 11 games in back-to-back years. Darrell K. Royal Texas Memorial Stadium, a sellout crowd, a perfect night for football, Charles.
You said it. And, you know, since we're in Austin, Texas, I think I can call you Pards tonight, right? since I'm in the perfect setting
Sure. Here.
This is a beautiful, beautiful place. My first time to Austin. I'm excited about this game. And you're exactly right. It's a perfect night for football. Temperature a little warm for those guys in the pads, but it should cool off nicely as we proceed along this evening.
And you can see the temperature. And there's Richmond McGee. He's going to be kicking it off for the Longhorns, who won the toss. They have deferred. Bruce Yeomans is back for Tulane on the far side of the field. Fred Smith, the freshman, is on the near side. The first time freshman ever touching. Fred Smith touched the ball this year. He took a kickoff back 100 yards for a touchdown.
No freshman jitters in that young man.
Not a bit. We are away in Austin. End over kick against the wind, and it'll be right on the end line. And Tulane will take over first and 10 from their own 20. And let's take a look at our U.S. Army of One starting lineups. The quarterback for Tulane. They're the number 8 passing offense in the NCAA. J.P. Lossman, the senior from Venice, California, began his career at UCLA. He is a very confident, shall we say, young man.
And that's a nice way of putting it. He's borderline cocky, and it took a while for the Tulane kids to truly buy into J.P. Lossman, but they have fully since he's taken over as a starting quarterback.
Tulane comes out with a formation of Mueldi Moore in the backfield. Lossman will go from the shotgun. They run everything from this formation. Chris Bush now in motion. Lossman keeps it on the ground to Moore. Cuts over the middle, crosses the 25 up to the 27-yard line. Pickup of about 6.5. Let's take a look at the rest of that Tulane offense. Their wide receiver, keep an eye on Roydell Williams. Only 3 games last year because of a fractured ankle, but he is the go-to guy tonight. And on the line, Jimmy Kaczynski. He's a junior, but he's the old man on the line. 4 sophomores surround Kaczynski on that old line. Can they handle that big defensive line of Texas?
Look for a lot of formations out of Tulane. Very basic plays, but they show them to you from a variety of angles, formations, and try and confuse the defense.
Season motion into the flat. Nice caught, then rock. Cedric Griffin put a hatchet job on him. Roydell Williams couldn't hold on to it. Let's take a look at the Texas defense. They haven't played a passing team like this yet this year. On the line, Marcus Tubbs. This young man didn't even start playing football till his junior year of high school. A lot of nickel coverage tonight. Linebackers all over the field, but as Charles mentioned, watch Derek Johnson. Nathan Basher in the secondary. He is the premier cornerback in all of college football.
Big third down early in the game. Last year, Tulane got a couple of first downs early before Texas was able to stop them. Again, lots of shifts, trying to get Texas to move and get out of position.
Again, Bush in motion. Moore trying to get that 4 yards, still on his feet, maybe gets one on the play. That'll bring up a 4th down and 3. Marcus Tubbs, the big senior out of DeSoto, Texas. He's the one who shot the gap and did the damage on Moore. Good first series for that Texas defense.
An excellent first series, and they were only tested once through the air, which is probably the surprise of the first series. But Tulane came out and ran the ball on two of their first three downs.
Chris Beckman was told, don't get anywhere near the Texas receivers on this punt, and he doesn't. You'd say it's not a good kick, but they didn't return it, so it is a good kick. Well, the fourth member of our broadcast team on the sideline enjoying the weather, Aaron Andrews.
Hey, Ron. Well, it's a family affair tonight for the Davises. Greg Davis Sr., the offensive coordinator here at the University of Texas, matching up against his son, Greg Davis Jr., the running backs coach over at Tulane. Father and son exchanging a few jabs this afternoon at the stadium. And guys, remember, Greg Davis Sr. telling us yesterday he was a little nervous about his briefcase. He didn't want his daughter-in-law, Karen, looking in there for any secrets for her husband, guys.
Makes for an interesting weekend.
Got to hide stuff from your own family.
Well, Texas takes over, first and 10 from their own 41-yard line. Mock quickly into the flat. Roy Williams just a touch out of his reach. Well, Chance Mock leads the number one scoring offense in the country. He is the first true Texan to start a quarterback for the Longhorns since James Brown. This young man has watched and learned from Major Applewhite and Chris Sims the last few years.
Yeah, able to have a red shirt year and also a couple years behind them. And this has been able, that's allowed him to break into this slowly. But he's had the full offense in his arsenal before he ever took a snap as a starter. Only his 4th start here at the University of Texas, despite being a junior.
Now Sloan Thomas comes to the near side. Brett Robin is in the ball game in the backfield. Cedric Benson has come out already. Tulane rushes four. They give it to Robin. Cuts over the left side. Goes over the 50. Down to about the 42-yard line. Pickup of 17 on the play for Brett Robin, the senior out of Austin Westlake High School.
Watch it. All it is misdirection, because you're going to see Brett Robin right here jab step and come back against the grain. This is like an old single wing play. Get every old flow going one way, cut back against the grain the opposite. You would think Cedric Benson would love to run that play and see that kind of a hole. But Brett Robin, a great senior, and boy, what a good carry for him to get things started.
Well, they rushed for 322 yards versus Rice. That's the most since the year 2000 against Kansas. Starting off good tonight, here's Cedric Benson. His first carry blasts over the middle. Down to the 35, to the 34-yard line, Sean Lucas, the sophomore out of Lathonia, Georgia, coming up to make the stop. Let's take a look at the rest of that Texas offense. Cedric Benson just made the carry, one of three running backs that have rushed for over 1,000 yards the last 2 years. On the line, he loves to run behind big Tillman Holloway, the senior. Coaches love Tillman Holloway's intensity.
They ran so well last week against Rice. Tillman Holloway was voted Offensive Player of the Week for the great blocking job he did opening holes for those 322 yards rushing.
Benson and Matthews in the I formation. Jay Johnson in motion. We've got people jumping all over the place. You know, let's talk about the fact that this Texas offensive line, Charles, averages 6'4", 304.
For
the
snap,
D-line of Tulane.
Start the offense. 5 yard penalty, still second down.
Randy Smith, our official, but the D-line of Tulane only averages 266. That's tough.
I think what you have is a recipe for Texas going right at them, as we're seeing thus far. Remember, all season long, Texas's offensive staff has talked about establishing the run. We need to establish the run. This is another perfect night for it.
Mm-hmm.
And if you can't do it against a defensive front that only averages 267, there'd be a lot of questions asked in the meetings on Sunday and Monday.
And there have been a lot of questions already asked about this Texas team, most of which have been unfair. Benson alone in the backfield. Second down, we'll call it six. On the 38. Mock, straight drop, penalty flags thrown. Going deep for Pater, dropped. B.J. Johnson had it in his hand. The cannon went off a tad premature.
I think it's going to work out well for Texas, because I think they're going to get a free play. It was a free play. And on a free play with a penalty against the other team, perfect time to throw it up deep and see what you get. And Texas almost cashed in on this play.
Offside on the defense, 5 yard penalty, still second down.
See Chris Selfo in our super shot, the head coach of Tulane. Watch at the end, as you see the defensive back coming across, Yeomans, very easily could have been called for pass interference, got in there just a tad early, but the officials are going to let them play for the ball. Both of them contesting for it. I don't have a real argument that they didn't drop a flag on that play.
Well, you're still looking at a pretty good situation if you're Texas. You're second and one.
Yeah, your playbook is fully open right now at second and short.
Give it to the fullback. Matthew barrels his way for the first down. As we take a look at the Tulane defense, opportunistic is the word to describe them. Tied for first in turnovers forced. The key, though, is on the line. Can Daniel Lovell, who leads them in tackles and sacks on the line, can they stand up to this big offensive line? Brant Quick at linebacker, he's just what you'd like to call a football player. Hard-nosed young man. Secondary, Sean Lucas. He's had to move over to safety from that right cornerback spot.
Great question you asked about, you know, Daniel Neville. Can he hold up? Because he's a former outside linebacker. Only weighs about 235 pounds on defensive end.
That's press book 235.
I understand that.
Mott, look out. He is spun around. Stays on his feet. Dumps it off into the flat. Pass is caught. David Thomas, the tight end.
Take a look at from an end zone shot, our All-State goalpost cam. Craig Morris, number 91, had the chance to wrap up Chance Mock and end the play right there. At the top of the show, Craig Sager talked to Frank Selfo, excuse me, to Coach Selfo at the top, and said, hey, what is it going to take to win this game? He said, making plays when we have the opportunity. They didn't get it done. Chris Selfo, excuse me, Frank Selfo is the offensive coordinator and Chris Selfo's brother.
You can see what he did against Rice last week, 8-for-8, came into this game 9-for-9, dating back to the Arkansas game. Mock again. This time sees some pressure, scrambling, throwing for his life. Incomplete pass. Got outside the tackle. Pressure put on by Brant Quick, the linebacker out of Mandeville, Louisiana, the former K-State Wildcat. Quick is a good player. He just flat out, he's got one speed.
All out.
All out.
And when we talked with his coach Eric Schumann yesterday, the defensive coordinator of Tulane, he said he's a guy who can look bad on one play and look great on another play, but in each situation, mm-hmm. he makes the play. He's not
That's
textbook
right.
all the time, but he gets there. And that was a nice play by Chance Mock, getting outside the pocket, throwing the ball away and avoiding the sack and loss of yardage.
Second down and 10, ball's on the 15-yard line. Benson, straight ahead, running, using the power, breaks over the 10 down to the 8-yard line. John Lucas coming up to make the stop. Trey Boger giving him a helping hand. Last week, Benson over 100 yards running the football. First time since last October he's been able to.
Coming right at you. Look at number 37 right there. Great block on the lead. Will Matthews leading up in the hole. You have to have a fullback in the I formation who's going to step inside and take on the big defensive tackles and the inside linebackers and clear a hole for the running back. And that play, Will Matthews did exactly that.
Third down and 4 on the 9-yard line. Johnson in motion. Mock looking for Johnson. Throws it out of the flat. Has an opening. No signal yet. They're saying at the 1-yard line. Take that back to 6-inch-yard line. 80,000 fans don't agree, but the one that counts is down there with white pants and a striped shirt.
We talked about Roy Williams at the top of the show, number 4, the wide receiver. He doesn't get this pass, but I'll tell you, he created the opportunity for Cedric Benson because he ended up getting double covered, and Benson looked like he powered his way into the end zone. Looked like a touchdown to me. I'm not sure. The official on the backside must have seen his foot go out of bounds, but we didn't. So, but it doesn't matter. They didn't call the touchdown.
Over the top, touchdown, Texas. Chance Mock's first rushing touchdown for the Longhorns this year. All set up by the Mock to B.J. Johnson toss.
Just a simple quarterback sneak. Now, I will tell you, I am not an advocate of a quarterback diving over the top because you lose momentum when you go over the top. It's much easier for the defensive line to knock you back and knock you to the side. But Chance Mock, all he has to do is get the ball across the goal line, break the plane. He was able to do it. I prefer to see him get down low and burrow, especially as big as strong as Chance Mock is. But right now he's saying, hey, man, I just scored, okay?
Right.
So don't worry about it.
Well, Dusty Mangum for the extra point. It is good. He's now made 111 straight PATs. Chance Mock's one tough cookie. Big Bertha's being pounded, and the Longhorns have an early lead. Chance Mock scores. Number 14, Texas leads 10:42 in the first, and it was all set up because of the rushing game.
Yeah, 59-yard drive and 9 plays, and they ran the ball very effectively. With Cedric Benson, they wanted to get him off early, and the offensive line created a big gap for him. And then the misdirection to Brett Robin, his backup, carried it deep into the secondary against Tulane. And what I've noticed early, good lead blocking by the fullbacks. Will Matthews, number 37 again, helping create space for Cedric Benson. The Texas running game is getting to the second and third level of Tulane's defense quickly in this ball game. Second level linebackers, third level defensive secondary.
Again, Richmond McGee knocks it out of bounds, and Tulane will have to take over for the second time on their second possession from their own 20. It took them 2 minutes and 58 seconds to cover 59 yards and 9 plays.
What they have to love is 36 rush yards. I mean, that's the key right there, 36 rush yards. They love the fact that they're going to run the ball early.
Let's listen in. We had a penalty
offside
on the kickoff.
The kicking team, a 5-yard penalty, re-kick.
Randy Smith out of Cleveland, Ohio. This is a little different weather for him.
A little warmer here than it is in Cleveland.
Yeah.
But I will tell you this, the special teams coach at Texas, none too happy right now. Mike Tollison. I mean, hey, you're not going to be thrilled at all. And offsides, when you're kicking off, you just scored, you have momentum. There's nothing worse than sending your guys back out there a second time. because there's a natural tendency to not go quite as hard the second time downfield, which can open up gaps and lanes. So right now they're saying to Richmond McGee, can you put it out of the end zone again, please?
We don't want to take a chance.
Put it out of the end zone because he's also 5 yards back. Now kicking from his own 30.
There's Fred Smith, the very talented freshman, averaging over 30 yards a return on kickoffs. McGee will try it again, kicking now with the wind. Wind starting to pick up a little bit here in Austin. And he boots this one 9 yards deep. Let's check in on the USC-Cal game with EJ. Ernie.
All right, thank you very much, Ron. Cal got on the board first on an Aaron Rodgers touchdown, but then here comes Southern Cal. Matt Leinart to Dominic Bird, the tight end, his first career touchdown for the sophomore. Game tied up, 7 apiece as they head to the second period, Ron.
All right, EJ, you'll have, of course, all the scores and highlights. A couple of upsets today. Congratulations, Coach Mangino at Kansas.
Huge game for them.
Big game.
Are they now 4-1?
4-1.
What a great job he's done in a short time in Lawrence, Kansas.
Keeping it on the ground with Bereldy Moore. This young man is one tough cookie. Not only was he drafted in pro baseball by the San Diego Padres, not only does he carry a double major, here's a guy, 2 straight 1,000-yard rushing seasons, but what makes him so dangerous, Charles, is this guy can catch the football.
Yeah, he's their leading receiver as well as their leading rusher, and also ranks highly in Conference USA, the all-time leading rusher, and one of the top, I think, top 20 receivers all time. This guy, as you said, does it all, a real tough guy, and also a wonderful young man. Everybody raves about what a terrific guy he is.
Texas showing 5 on the line, defensive line of scrimmage. The fake by Lossman. Pressure, that's what Texas wants. Tries to get away with it, loses the ball on the ground. Texas has it down to the 12. Derek Johnson.
This was set up by number 98, Brian Pickerel. Watch where he comes from the rush, from the left-hand side. He created the chaos, and then when Lossman tried to get at relieve pressure, he never tucked the ball away. Roderick Wright, number 90, strips the ball, and who's on the spot? We talked about him at the beginning, Derek Johnson, their do-everything linebacker. He's already returned an interception for a touchdown this season against New Mexico State. Close, very close there, almost took in a fumble.
The junior out of Waco, Texas. Mock pitching, Benson. Looking for some running room, being stacked up back at the 14-yard line. Anthony Cannon, Sean Lucas stacking them up. One thing we noticed watching the tape of a couple of these Tulane games, yes, Texas scored, yes, they got the break. Tulane never gave up in any of their games. They've had to come back from behind in all the games, but these guys play hard.
They do. They were down 31-7 in the fourth quarter against TCU, came back and lost the game by 3. They scored 28 points in the fourth quarter. Down 17 with 4 minutes and 50 seconds to go at home against Mississippi State, won the ball game in regulation. They do know how to come back from adversity.
One of the things Chris Sealfield cannot afford his team to do is give Texas this short field. Into the flat, Williams completes, spins, catches, touchdown! Roy Williams is so dangerous on those yak yards, those yards after catch. He is probably one of, if not the best in college football after he gets the ball.
Take a look out here. That's number 4, Roy Williams. You mentioned, Ron, they can't afford the short field. It's just a little simple route. Just sits down, and then there's a missed tackle by number 20, Bruce Yeomans, and then he outruns everyone else to the corner. I mean, we knew he was good coming in, but that's the type of play, and I saw about 25 pro scouts file into the stadium tonight. They just threw their hands up and threw their notebooks away and recorders because they don't need to file a report.
He's real.
Here it is. This is the guy.
Roy Williams, his 4th touchdown reception of the year. He could be the number 1 pick in the upcoming NFL draft, and that is one reason why.
Welcome back to Austin, Texas, up 14-0. Their star, Roy Williams, right there. He's going to run just a little simple sit-down route, 5-yard hitch. makes the catch, and then right here, Tulane's going to miss the first tackle. Brucioma's number 20. Now watch. Right there, the stiff arm on Trey Boger, number 2. The best tackling defensive back for Tulane. He was Conference USA's Player of the Week 2 weeks ago against Mississippi State. Roy Williams made it look easy against a very good player.
Tulane had only given up 6 points the entire year in the first quarter coming into this game. They've already got stung for 14. And Chris Selfo said, we got to play the perfect game. Well, missed tackles, fumbles, that's far from perfect.
Not catching the ball early in the ball game. Mm-hmm. You know, all the things that he talked about. We have to make plays when we have an opportunity. And thus far, we say Tulane hasn't done that at all.
Again, no return, and again, average field position for Tulane. Our next telecast will be coming your way next Saturday night, 7 o'clock Eastern, as the number 1 ranked Oklahoma Sooners take on Dan McCartney's Iowa State Cyclones. We will be in Ames, Iowa for that ball game. Our first look at Jason White, Teddy Lehman and company.
That ought to be fun to watch. And Ames, Iowa is a great atmosphere for college football. They've sold that one out, of course. And, you know, Iowa State's got a tough one tonight at Northern Illinois.
And it's a week before the OU-Texas game. Will OU be distracted? My answer is no.
Has Bob Stoops ever, has he ever let that team be distracted?
Not going to happen.
Tulane spreading it out. No one in the backfield.
High snap. Wasserman has to bring it down. Running again. And he's dumped again. Greg Sager is on the sideline, Sags.
His game plan already has been amended. Before the game, Coach Selfo kept his entire team in the locker room. He did not want them to see any part of the Texas tradition that's been going on for 40 years, where they have the fight song, the March of the Longhorns, the anthem, then the state song, Texas Our Texas, the big block D, big birth of the big drum. He wanted to keep them in there to avoid anything that would get them intimidated. But obviously down 14 to nothing, he's got to give another pep talk already.
I think Roy Williams intimidated more than Big Bertha. Pass is knocked down. Tipped by Roderick Wright, the very talented sophomore out of Houston, Texas, A. Leif Hastings High School. Big 12 defensive freshman player of the year. He is going to be a dandy as he gets older, believe it or not.
Yes, as he grows into his body. They called him the freestyle king last year as he was trying to learn the defense, not playing it the way he was supposed to be. But his talent is so overwhelming, he still made plays. Now he's playing within the confines of the defense and doing all the right things. And we saw the result, a blocked pass. J.P. Rossman had a number of those batted back at him by Mississippi State's defensive line.
Tulane still looking for their first down. Five wide receiver set. Wasserman, quick throw. Pass is complete to Roy L. Williams. The 30, the 40, the 50. Look out! Two Longhorns chasing him to the 10, to the 6. Nathan Vasher, the saving tackle, but what a catch and run by Roy L. Williams.
Watch Roy Dell Williams coming at you from the end zone. Just a simple pattern, a hitch pattern that Roy Williams ran. And what a great move he put in on the secondary on Cedric Griffin. And then actually Cedric Griffin came back to Adam again and made him miss a second time before he was run down by Nathan Vasher.
Moore looking for Painter. Bounces out outside. Touchdown Tulane. We told you it was a high-powered, quick-striking offense. How about that? 77 yards to Roy Dell Williams, his longest of the year, and then Moore taking it in for only his second rushing touchdown of the year.
Did you say that this Tulane team doesn't give up? They're used to being in this position, down against a bigger opponent, but they tend to come back against them. And right away, Tulane gets that done, a two-play strike. What a great job by the Green Wave, bouncing off of the deck and already getting back into the ball game.
Barrett Pepper, freshman out of Bastrop, Louisiana. Low snap block. Still on the ground. He can go with it. And Pepper brings him down. That ball never got higher than about 4 feet, and it was blocked. But Moeldy Moore with the touchdown pulls Tulane within 8.
We choose not to sleep. We choose instead to explore. We choose to invent, to discover, to cure, to lead. We choose not to sleep. make some coffee. We're Texas.
Texas leading 14-6. How about a little Capital Cruise there?
Oh, with sing a little, it, baby.
That little Stevie Ray Vaughan in the background? You want to come
thought,
to...
I thought that was you.
That was me last night. You want to come to a beautiful city, come to Austin, Texas. We talk about the two big play guys. How about Roy Williams and Roy Dell Williams? Not too bad so far, huh?
And look at that. Roy Dell from Tulane and Roy from Texas. But it's amazing, without knowing each other, Roy Williams' nickname by the Texas team is Roy Dell.
What a hit. Back at the 28-yard line, Texas will take over. First and 10. Patrick Bedford on the tackle. Now the crowd of over 80,000 want to get something going as Vince Young, the redshirt freshman out of Madison High School down in Houston, comes in. This is what they did last week against Rice on the third series. He came in, led him to a touchdown. This is an extremely talented young man also.
And what they did last week was substitute the offensive line also, the second team line, and I believe they've done the same thing tonight. Put the second unit in with Vince Young.
Young throws behind Roy Williams. Young, though, wins games. He's got a great arm. I mean, the young man's big. He's 6'5", 220 pounds. But he really can win games with his legs. Not taking anything away from Chance Mock. Chance Mock is the starting quarterback, and he is the number one guy. But they want to get ready for conference season. Mac Brown telling us over the last couple of days that he wanted him as ready as he could possibly be by the time the Big 12 conference starts.
And it's not a quarterback controversy.
Not a bit.
It's a quarterback competition. And Chance Mock is the leader of this competition.
Young keeps it. This is where he is dangerous. The crowd stands up as Young goes to the 40, to the 30. Knocked out of bounds at about the 11-yard line. They'll mark it at the 10. His longest run in a Texas Longhorn uniform, 60 yards.
And this is how Greg Davis, the offensive coordinator for Texas, has expanded their playbook. They put in running plays for the quarterback. That's a quarterback zone play. Fake the ball inside to the running back out of the shotgun. Read the defensive end. If the end crashes inside with the running back, you keep it and take it outside. If he stays outside, you hand it off inside to the running back. Obviously, Vince Young made the proper read.
A new place for these two quarterbacks because they're much more athletic than the past couple of years. Robin on the carry over the left side. Barrels his way down to about the 5-yard line. Of course, Iowa State will be in Ames, Iowa next week. They're playing Northern Illinois, and Northern Illinois wins by 8. That's the final. And Northern Illinois is a good team.
And that was not an upset. Northern Illinois came into the game as the favorite. Game was in DeKalb. Yeah, you know, and people knew going in there that was going to be very tough for Iowa State to handle. Joe Novak has done a fantastic job. Great patience by the Northern Illinois administration keeping that guy around.
High formation. Robin inside the 5, down to about the 3-yard line. He's stacked up. This Texas offense came into this game looking for consistency and explosive plays. I have to think they got him both so far tonight. Still early in the game, though.
Yeah, the only negative for Texas thus far is they gave up an explosive play.
That's right.
To Tulane. Explosive plays as defined by Texas. 12 yards or more on a running play, 16 yards or more on a pass play. I think right now they'd like to pound the ball in and show their toughness running the ball.
Third down and goal. Young keeps it, looks it in the flat, throws, touchdown, flag thrown, though. David Thomas with the catch, but there is a penalty flag on the ground.
Or they'd like to show a little fake inside.
Whatever.
And bring it out and throw the pass to the tight end.
That's what you meant to say. Now the touchdown will go. David Thomas out of Friendship High School in Wolfville, Texas.
Penalties declined. Touchdown.
Nice little boot action. And all they did was misdirect with the tight end. David Thomas, number 16, went in motion against flow and then came back the opposite way. After they faked the ball inside, He came into the flat, was wide open, easy throw for Vince Young. And what that accomplishes for Texas is confidence.
Absolutely.
For a young quarterback. Another drive for a touchdown, and he caps it with a touchdown pass.
Young's first career touchdown pass, David Thomas's first touchdown reception. The extra point is perfect. Let's send it back to Atlanta for an update on Southern Cal and Cal. Ernie.
Thank you, Rob.
Buddy Stevens, I'm telling you, about Jeff Tedford, he's got quite a team up there.
He's a big-time coach. We saw it last year when he took over a team that was decimated by probation, knew they couldn't go to a bowl game, went 1-10 the previous season, and he fashioned a 7-5 record with a team in a very short amount of time. And this year, everyone thought they wouldn't be any good because they lost 20-plus seniors, most of whom played key roles. And thus far this year, they've not been an easy out anywhere along the way. He's an excellent football coach.
Fred Smith back to receive this. We still have, my friends, 6 minutes and 14 seconds left in the first quarter. And 27 points have already been scored. If you have any late plans tonight, you might want to cancel. This may be a while.
Excuse me, can we push dinner back an hour? Thank you.
11:30. Israel Rout and Fred Smith back to receive the kick.
Garcon, Mr. Thulin, could you hold this table an extra hour?
McDonald's is open all the time. Another one out of the end zone, and Tulane, first and 10 from their own 20. Big plays have been the highlight of tonight so far.
Well, Greg Davis, the offense coordinator, told us we want explosive plays, and they're getting them in the run game and the pass game. Cedric Benson carrying it down to the 1 foot line before Roderick Wright on defense stripped J.P. Lossman, and then Vince Young on the quarterback zone play. A long gallop deep into the secondary of Tulane that led to the last touchdown by Texas. They're up 21-6.
Have we breathed yet? I'm just curious.
And I don't think Tulane's going to give us an opportunity to do that. They're going to come right back at them.
Lossman rolling out, being chased, gets rid of it as he's hit. Pass is incomplete. Intended for Bubba Terranova, the sophomore out of Slidell, Louisiana. Kalen Thornton coming up to put the pressure on Lossman, the senior out of St. Mark's High School in Dallas, Texas. It's a good shot at Thornton. What a great transition for this young man. St. Mark's High School in Dallas, famous for people like Boz Skaggs, Steve Miller, to name a few. Not necessarily football players. Great transition from a small private school to big-time college.
But it seems as if Kalen Thornton is in sync this year. You know, he's got legs back under him after a lot of injuries, and he showed off his speed chasing down J.P. Lossman on that last play.
Second and 10, another high snap, looks right, throws over the middle, pass is complete. Tristan Smith with the reception, that'll be good enough for a first down. A lot of NFL scouts are here tonight. With more on that, here's Craig Sager.
Well, Ron, Charles mentioned the 25 NFL scouts you saw coming in. Over half the league is here. Most of them are here to see J.P. Lossman. I talked to several of them before the game. I said, what can you see here in person that you can't see by game films? They said, we are looking for how he moves around in the pocket, how he competes, how he runs the game, how he handles adversity, and is he coachable on the sidelines? The adversity setting in right now.
Good point. Lossman looks at a four-man rush, steps up in the pocket. Takes a lick as he gets up to the 40-yard line. Again, it is Kalen Thornton on the stop. Last couple of years, Tulane's had some pretty good quarterbacks starting back to the 95-98 season. How about Sean King, Charles? Not a bad little player.
Yeah, he led them to a 12-0 record in 1998. Undefeated season, I believe they finished number 7 in the country with a Liberty Bowl win. And, of course, Patrick Ramsey, now the starting quarterback for the Washington Redskins in the fun and gun in our nation's capital.
Well, Lossman will be the third straight Tulane quarterback to be drafted.
And could be another first rounder following Patrick Ramsey.
This time they try the ground game. They hand it off to Moore. Kind of cross bucks over the left side. Picks up a couple of yards again. Kalen Thornton on the tackle.
You know, that report that Craig gave us on what the scouts are looking for with J.P. Lossman. Remember, he lost the ball the series before when Roderick Wright stripped the ball out. Did you notice on the last scramble he had what he did when he felt pressure? Tucked the ball away. Oh. He's a quick learner. The scouts will write that down in their books and in their recorder. They'll like seeing that.
Third down and 2 from the 42-yard line.
Full pressure. Look at everyone up in press coverage with a safety back. Man-free coverage.
Smith in motion. Lossman has to scramble again. Squares his shoulders, throws it too high and incomplete. Had a couple of different receivers out there, but Tim Crowder, the true freshman out of just up the road in Tyler, Texas, John Tyler High School, putting on the big-time pressure.
Is that another Tyler Rose?
Yeah.
But you know, if you're playing defensive end, Earl Campbell was the Tyler Rose, right?
That's right.
But if you're playing defensive end, you got to be the thorn. You know, you can't be the smooth guy. You got to be the thorn, and Tim Crowder on that play was definitely that on the side of J.P. Boston.
The punt back to the 14-yard line. Delvin Young. Oh, my, that should be a penalty, a little hit out of bounds. Nathan Vasher, I should say. Both have the same number, Vasher and Selvin Young. Neville puts the hit on him, and that'll draw some laundry.
Well, first thing, Chris Selfo is going to ask his punter why Nathan Vasher was able to field the punt. He told us yesterday in a meeting, we're punting away. Our goal is 35 yards and no return. We'll take that. But Nathan Vasher actually fielded that punt. I don't think that's what was in their game plan.
After the play, personal foul. The kicking team, 15 yards and end the run, first down.
Well, Charles, we've talked about this
gotta
before.
Be smarter on the sidelines.
Right. It's J.P. Lossman on the phone. But when your margin of error is slim, and realistically that's what it is for Chris Selfo, and you can see the look on his face, those are penalties that just drive a coach nuts, because you can't make those kind of mistakes to come in here in Austin and expect to win.
No, and the offense is making some decent plays, just not enough of them right now. The defense bearing the brunt of the pressure right now, trying to keep Texas out of the end zone again.
Given the Wolves a great field position, which they have taken advantage of so far tonight. Mock back in at quarterback. He's got some running room. Should get the first down. Tack on a couple of more. Still on his feet, but he stepped out of bounds at about the 44-yard line, we'll call it.
There's the toughness, the cowboy mentality of Chance Mock right next to the sideline. Quarterback at that point plays over. You got all you need. Get out of bounds. What does he do? Try and stay in bounds and go back into traffic. That's that linebacker of his father. You know, his dad was a linebacker, went to the NFL.
Played for Bill Parcells.
That's that tough guy mentality. That I'm sure that Mac Brown and Greg Davis say, okay, Chance, we know you're tough. Get out of bounds for us.
Well, he says his dad's not telling him, you know, please be smarter. don't take a guy on like he used to.
Look at that production, 9.1 yards every play.
Benson left side, puts the shoulder down, crosses the 35, down to the 32-yard line. Alton Weidman coming up to make the stop. Benson in the first two games, and we saw the tapes of every game they played, was not patient running the football. Wasn't running behind his shoulders, as coach likes to say. Boy, that has changed the last 2 weeks.
He worked so hard in the offseason, redefining his body, added about 10, 11 pounds of muscle, didn't play baseball in the Dodgers farm system to get ready. He may have been a little bit over-anxious. I think he's settled in pretty well now the last 2 weeks.
Another first down for the Longhorns, ball on the 31-yard line. Three wide receivers, two to the right, one to the left. Keeping it on the ground. Benson bouncing off tackles, keeps the feet moving. Down to about the 25-yard line. Again, Sean Lucas making the stop, but not before Benson picks up 11.
The surge of the Texas offensive line has been a big part of the story of the game. Because Cedric Benson, watch who touches him first. See, no one in the defensive line is getting to him. The first guy is number 31, Sean Lucas, the free safety. That means he's getting to the third level of the Tulane defense without being touched.
Mm-hmm.
So Mac McWhorter, the new offensive line coach, has to be very happy. Look at the rushing offenses of the two teams. I mean, the rushing offense of Texas against Tulane's defense, it's a strength of Texas going against a weakness of the Green Wave.
Well, another first down for the Longhorns. That's their 10th already in the game, and we're still in the first quarter. Mock, play action. Cutting across the field down to about the 14-yard line is Tony Jeffrey.
Tony Jeffrey.
Junior out of Houston, Texas, Klein Forest High School. His first catch. Well, our first and 10 line is brought to you by Home Depot. You know, you mentioned Mac McWhorter, and they brought him in, of course, a former Georgia lineman, worked wonders at Georgia, Clemson, Georgia Tech, Alabama, was a Georgia Tech interim coach, but he came in with a different blocking scheme. A little more aggressive, more knocking on your fanny instead of standing around kind of like.
Yeah, he coached the tight ends last year, and they gave him the whole offensive line this year. His big thing is he's not even really the system, it's the mindset. It's knock people back.
Ball is on the ground. Let's see who's got it. I think Tulane has it, and they do. Cedric Benson last year against Tulane had a string of 225 carries without a fumble snapped. And he fumbles again. That's only his seventh fumble of his career.
Yeah, he fumbles roughly once every 100 times. Let's see if he gets it clean. He got the ball, looked at me from the backside, couldn't see the front, but it seemed like Chance Mock put it in the pocket in the proper place as he tried to slide it across. I don't know if he got it all the way across and got it into the bread basket or not, or if maybe things are just slippery because you get sweaty down there. In any event, they'll be talking about it again. Another forced turnover for Tulane, tied for first in the country going into this weekend with UNLV, their first of the night.
So Boger fell on that loose ball. Lossman throws it out on the flat. Moore makes the one-handed grab, and he's going to lose a couple of yards on the play. Philip Giger there to make the stop, the junior out of Shreveport, Louisiana.
You know, at the top of the game, we discussed Derek Johnson, number 11, being the shadow guy on Mwelde Moore. But what Carl Reese has done is brought in additional defensive backs, playing mainly a nickel package. Philip Giger, number 22, he was operating as the shadow on Mwelde Moore, made a nice open field tackle.
Now, Texas is going to be using a lot of defensive schemes here. They're showing four. Sometimes they won't even rush.
It looks like man-free coverage again. Man coverage for free safety open.
Is complete to Roydell Williams, who gets close to the 20-yard line. Pickup of maybe four on the play. Marcus Tubbs on the stop.
Other than the one huge play by Roydell Williams, Texas has tackled very well tonight.
Right.
When the ball's been thrown and caught, they've usually been put down within a yard of where they caught the ball. That's what Carl Reese was looking for from his secondary.
Lossman leads the NCAA in touchdown passes and yards, number two in total offense. Now facing a third and eight.
See if Texas goes after him here.
Here they come. Lossman throwing on the run. Pass is complete. First down, Chris Bush. Now, Bush has been a touch inconsistent. Last year in this Texas game, he dropped a couple of passes that could have been touchdowns. Coaches said he's the guy that has to step up tonight.
And he's done that thus far this season, too, but he's getting better. And it was huge for him to catch the first pass thrown to him tonight so that there was no carryover from last year's game. Because if he had dropped the first one, that's the first thing that would have gone through his mind. And that was a big completion to him for a first down.
Final 20 seconds of the opening quarter, 21-6, Texas leading Tulane. Nothing doing on the ground. Roderick Wright coming up to make the stop, and that should be the end of a very exciting first quarter of play. So Tulane, who came into this game having given up only 6 first quarter points all year, give up 21 to Texas. And as we head to quarter number 2, the Longhorns lead the Green Wave 21-6. Welcome back to College Football on TBS, part of Big Play Station Saturday, as we get set to start the second quarter. Texas leading Tulane 21-6. Along with Charles Davis, Craig Sager, and Aaron Andrews, I'm Ron Thulin. Welcome you to Darrell K. Royal Texas Memorial Stadium, and a beautiful night here in Austin, Texas. 83,120, ninth best overall crowd in the history of this stadium. Second down and 11 for Tulane, going from left to right. Longhorns bring 5. Lossman picks it up, tries to thread the needle, knocked down by Derek Johnson. One of the things Texas is charting tonight, how many times they pressure and get to J.P. Lossman.
Well, you see the hurries, 2, 3 hits, 3 knockdowns, 2 sacks. But Lossman expects to be under pressure. They talk about him as the quarterback being the blitz control guy. Expects someone to come free, and he starts to make the throw. Thus far, 50% on the night. The big one to Roydell Williams, a short pass that turned into a long game.
That's 10 out of about 20 plays. Something was happening to him. That's a pretty good percentage.
That's why he built up his body to 220 pounds through the weight room.
Here comes the blitz. They pick it up. Lossman throwing deep into the flat, incomplete. Looking for Nick Narcisse on the far side of the field. Couldn't find him. Nick didn't turn around quick enough.
Coverage was excellent the last 2 plays by Texas. The previous play, Philip Giger and Derek Johnson sandwiching the receiver, knocking the ball away. On the last one, Nick Narcisse, as you said, didn't turn around very quickly. J.P. Lossman really didn't have anywhere to go with the football.
Chris Beckman, the precision punter. Nathan Vasher in the back. He wasn't very precise on that second punt. Actually let Vasher field it.
But let's see if he kicks it towards us this time. Now let's get another chance.
Vasher runs up. He's going to return it from the 35. The wall is forming. Vasher down to the the 25 to the 24-yard line, and a penalty flag is at the 50. Why, oh, why do you kick to him? It's like
it makes
Oklahoma
no sense.
Last week.
It makes no sense. We had this discussion last night. Chris Silfo was emphatic in telling us we're kicking it into the stands. We're kicking it away. And naturally, on a great return, what do we have? A flag, a hold, or something like that against Texas. But watch the block. Look to the left of your screen and see who makes the block. See right there? That was Roy Williams.
Roy Williams.
The All-American receiver, and they may have called him for the clip.
10-yard penalty for the spot of the foul. First down.
Don't they know who he is?
you know, all Americans are supposed to get
yeah,
that flag.
Really.
If it were basketball, he'd get that call, right?
Michael Jordan and traveling. Come on, you know.
But how interesting is that? That an all-American receiver is on the punt return unit, throwing blocks. He also is on the kick, you know, block kick unit, right? He's one of the guys they like to use to block kicks. But they have tradition around here. All remember Earl Campbell's big block in the 70s, blocking a punt that Doug English ran in for a touchdown. So they use their players to the best of their abilities.
B.J. Johnson lines up behind Roy Williams, far side. High formation, Johnson in motion. Mock looks, has the arm hit, and that's going nowhere. Brandon Spencer, I think, is the one that may have got the arm of Chance Mock, and that is dangerous. Quarterbacks can get hurt with that.
You know, in college, I think my English professor would say this is much ado about nothing. There's a fake to the inside, another fake on reverse. Great job of hiding the ball by Chance Mock, but Cedric Benson, number 32, could not hold the block on Brandon Spencer, the linebacker. He was trying to throw the ball deep down the sideline to the All-American Roy Williams in a one-on-one coverage.
I think coaches would probably want that to develop a tad more quickly.
A little more quickly,
little quicker.
And the running back has to block the linebacker to give the quarterback a chance.
Lane shows blitz. They keep it on the ground with Robin. Right side. First down. Over the 50. Down to the 44-yard line.
25, Brett Robin on the carry. 21, Sean Lewis.
What a great story of Brett Robin, the young man out of Westlake High School here in Austin, a pre-med student with a 3.75 grade point.
And right now, he's rocking Robin, running the misdirection play for the second time tonight for big yardage. Great job by the offensive line, taking people to one side and opening the lane, running back across the green for the running back, Brett Robin.
21 yards on the pickup, his longest rush of this season.
And following the footsteps of his dad, Dr. Sid Robin, and become a doctor.
Locked a little hesitation, has the rush, and oh, he takes a lick back at the 48-yard line. Torian Brown, the redshirt freshman out of Katy, Texas, which is just outside of Houston. Well, I tell you what, he put a wallop on Mock.
And another play that appeared that Texas had plenty of time to find a receiver, but Torian Brown came free on a twist up front. Lineman goes one way, Torian Brown loops around behind the other one, came clean, no one picked him up. He gets the knockdown on Chance Mock. He's in for Bam Mateen, who's out with a broken foot.
Some of these Texas players want to show Mac Brown they should have recruited him. Mock fakes right, throws left. Sloan Thomas has some running room. He's dangerous. Look out. To the 20, to the 15, down to the 10-yard line, Sloan Thomas. 46 yards.
This is the jailbreak screen, Ron. Watch the lineman coming out here to kick out, and also watch the outside, watch the wide receivers helping block. But they get linemen downfield also, and Sloan Thomas makes the first guy miss, and then he gets good blocks downfield, and off to the races he goes. The jailbreak screen when a lineman pulls out the block. The bubble screen, just the receivers out front for the wide receiver screen.
36 yards, that's the sixth explosive play for Texas. People jumping all over the place, free play for the Longhorns. Mock in the end zone, touchdown.
And I think Tulane was in the neutral zone, and if it goes that way, this touchdown should hold up for Bo Scaife, the tight end, number 80.
Well, David Thomas, the tight end, got his first touchdown.
Penalty's declined. Touchdown.
And there was a penalty on the play that was declined. Now Chris Selfo's team gives up a touchdown to Bo Scaife, his first touchdown of the year.
Well, we knew that Tulane's offense was explosive. We knew Texas's was explosive. And right now, the Texas defense has been the story of the game. Other than the long play to Roydell Williams and subsequently giving up a touchdown, they've held J.P. Lossman and their high-octane offense in check.
Mangum for the extra point. And then we'll go to the cannon. Aaron Andrews.
How's that for you, guys? I'm here with the Texas Cowboys. That's what you do after a score here at the University of Texas, guys.
Go Horns! Go Horns!
All right, the Longhorns are very successful on offense tonight. They lead 28-6, still 12:48 left in the first half. Early in the second quarter, number 14, Texas showing why they are number 14.
Well, take a look, because what's going to happen, take a look at the tight end here, that's Bo Scape. He's going to run a route down into the end zone, and Chance Mock's going to use his mobility to get outside, see? And when he moves a little bit outside the pocket with his feet, waits for Bo Scape to make his break into the end zone, and a perfect throw, low and away. Only guy who could have caught it was Texas Longhorn Bo Scape.
From about the 3-yard line. Smith gets up to the 23-yard line, their best starting field position in a while, and it's time now for our fan rant, brought to you by Kia Motors, which reminds you to make every mile count.
I thought Paul Williams was shorter and a singer.
How about a little razzle and somewhat of a dazzle? I tell you, Tristan Smith didn't fake out a whole lot of people. You know, we talked about this, the best starting field position for Tulane. Every one of their drives started on the 20-yard line or the 16-yard line. Starting where they did, that's kind of a breather for this offense.
It is, and that tells you what we're looking at now with the score 28-6, because it was a first down. It was a first down run, but when you run some razzle-dazzle, you're actually hoping the play breaks bigger. Mm-hmm. You know, when you run the reverses and all sorts of things like that, 10 yards is great, but you're actually hoping for a little bit more.
The longest rush for Tristan Smith this year. Four wide receivers, another high snap. Lossman looking someplace to go. All he sees is Burt Orange and the body of Kalen Thornton. Of course, they had that 12th defender called the sideline, which helped out a little bit.
Oh, Sammy Sideline. My coach Johnny Majors talked about Sammy Sideline as if he were a real person. If you didn't use him well, you would think he was a real person, because you'd get acquainted with Sammy Bench. You didn't use him real well.
You did say bench, right?
Oh, okay, without a doubt. Okay. I got plenty of splinters I'm still pulling out to show for not using him well. But that last play by Lossman, it looked like an option, except it's more of an option shovel pass with Moel Day Moore, because Lossman would have had to throw it forward to him. But Moel Day Moore was covered on the play. He had to keep it.
Lossman looking, rifles the ball, and it is caught. Chris Bush. Well, the big play so far for Tulane was the pass from Lossman to Roydell Williams. And
yeah, that's been the big breaker for him so far. When he got it outside and Roydell Williams able to make a move and get down the sideline.
Now Maloney Moore stays on his feet, looks for the 40-yard line, tiptoes inside the 35-yard line, pushed out of bounds at the 30-yard line.
26.
Talk about great balance. Noelde Moore just kind of shook a couple tackles off and kept his balance.
Now watch as he makes this run. Okay, we're going to take the end zone look. Moore, watch number 6, Mike Williams, right here coming up the defensive end. There's a missed tackle. And then watch the straight arm that he puts on the All-American, Nathan Vasher, and then still has enough balance to stay in bounds and gain more yardage.
And they stay on the ground in the middle, nothing going on. We want to thank Allstate for providing tonight's goalpost cam. You're in good hands with Allstate. Well, Moeldy Moore, they want to make sure he gets 25 to 30 touches a game. And that's what they want. They want to get the ball in this young man's hands.
And right now, I'd have to say they're behind pace in the numbers of touches that he's got.
He's got 9. Austin's going to take a seat back at the 34-yard line. Reed Boyd, the senior out of New Braunfels, Texas, with a stop. Boyd out of the same high school as Cliff Kingsbury, former Texas Tech Red Raider.
What a great play by Reed Boyd. Reed Boyd, who played middle linebacker last year, but then moved him to the strong side this year, and he stays on the field in most situations, including the nickel package. And we just saw evidence of why. Great speed and agility, keeping up with the quarterback moving outside the pocket.
Third down and 14. Five wide receivers, an empty backfield. Texas, Quist brings four. Lossman, dangerous pass, incomplete.
Oh, did you see who broke on that one?
Derek Johnson thought he saw some golden goalposts.
Now look, I don't want to go over the top here, but he looked like a defensive back on this play. Wearing number 11, he plays linebacker. See how he broke on it? He thought he had a chance for an interception. The ball was thrown high and away, and he forces the incompletion. Derek Johnson can do anything you want on a football field. Anything.
Roderick Wright was putting the pressure on fourth down, and we'll call it a bunch. 14.
Got to go for it, though, don't they?
Well, play clock's down to 12. Little confusion.
But since they don't have to huddle, that saves them time. They should still get it off.
Play clock at 5. Fourth and 14. Play clock at 1. Gets it away. Lossman looking, throwing. Has a man, incomplete. Intended for Tristan Smith, just couldn't get the hands on it.
The route was there. He actually used the wide receiver, Carl Davis, number 83, to run a short route, hoping to suck the secondary up and use Tristan Smith in a one-on-one route against Cedric Griffin, number 8. Ball was thrown a little wide. Tristan Smith unable to come up with it. Texas takes over on downs.
And Texas will take over. Good field position, first and 10 from their own 34-yard line. Vince Young back in, back at quarterback. Young looking, throwing, pass too low. Roy Williams can't bend over that far.
Whoa, love to have that one back, wouldn't he?
He was wide open.
Roy Williams on a crossing route for a quarterback, that's supposed to be heaven.
Mm-hmm.
If you get the ball to him running through the secondary on a crossing route and hit him in stride, monster play for you.
Well, that's the second time Young had an open receiver that had an errant throw. Chance Mock has only really had one bad throw tonight.
Now, this is why they're getting him some experience and getting him in. We saw what happened with Kansas State when Earl Roberson got hurt. You've got to have a second quarterback who's ready to play in the Big 12.
Robin cuts back, gets over the 35 to the 37-yard line. Let's get an update on Alabama and Arkansas with Ernie Johnson. EJ?
All right.
You know, Charles, that was the big talk here in Austin. Is Arkansas that good, or was Texas that flat that day? And everybody had this as the benchmark game, Arkansas-Alabama.
Well, Alabama was off to a big lead, and Arkansas showing some resilience. They're back in at second overtime, and they're no strangers to OT. They've won, 6 last year with Tennessee?
Third down and 7. Young floats the pass. What a touch pass. Complete to B.J. Johnson.
Mentioned the touch. This cannot be thrown any better. B.J. Johnson running a 7 route or a flag route. Going to the sideline. Perfectly thrown ball, and how nice was that coming back after missing Roy Williams wide open earlier in the series.
27 yards on the pickup. Johnson's first reception of the night. First and 10 now from the 36. Young keeps, pitches. Robin stops, spins, gets down to the 30-yard line. SI.com is your source for scores and breaking sports news. Welcoming you back to Darrell K. Royal, Texas Memorial Stadium in beautiful Austin, Texas. 28-6 is our score. Texas leading Tulane, and it has been offensive fireworks on the part of both teams.
Well, have we seen an expanded Texas playbook that Greg Davis has put in? It's not just for Vince Young. It's for Vince Young and Chance Mock. Don't be surprised to see Mock also run option in zone plays.
Robin, right side, first down, puts his head down and barrels down to the 22-yard line. Well, the offensive coordinator of Texas is Greg Davis, and he likes to stretch things out, and there's Major Applewhite.
Is that look at Major. Is he working?
I'm telling you. talking to him on Thursday, I said, how is it? He goes, oh, I don't get any sleep.
And there's Greg Davis right there next to him, the offensive coordinator.
He's going to need glasses. Major's going to need glasses.
He'll learn. You saw Greg has them. Huh? You see that?
Yeah, look at it. He's going to look like the rest of us.
And Major Applewhite is working with offensive linemen more than he's working with quarterbacks, learning the total offense in his evolution as a coach.
Young, complete to the 10, down to the 8-yard line. Bo Scape, the big tight end. The one thing we saw last week in the Rice game and tonight, Young and the quarterbacks of Texas are going to the tight ends.
And well, as well they should. David Thomas, Bo Scape, you're not going to find two better tight ends in the country. Bo Scape has battled back from a couple of knee surgeries, and he's back. Look at the straight arm he lays on Sean Lucas, number 31, before Anthony Cannon, the terrific sophomore linebacker, brings him down in the secondary.
Scape's second reception of the night. First one was a touchdown. Ball from the line, ball's on the ground. Young and Robin try to cover it up. Vince Young comes up with it. You know, you talked about Major Applewhite working with the offensive line. He was telling us on Thursday as we were watching practice, he says, you know, I also have Max let me work with the quarterbacks on occasion, and he says he's mainly spending time with Vince Young. And Vince Young, he's practicing even how he calls plays.
Yeah, Vince Young practices how he calls the plays in the offense in a mirror in his room to make sure that he gets things right, because he's a young quarterback still learning, and there's a lot of terminology that comes out of these playbooks.
Well, Vince Young does the smart thing, calls a timeout with 8:03 left in the half. Second down and goal from the 13 with a big lead. College football on TBS brought to you by Philips Digital Widescreen Projection Televisions and Kia Motors. 7 cars, 1 belief. Kia, make every motor count. Welcome back. Is Texas in the red zone again tonight? They are 4 of 4 in the red zone, 17 of 18 for the year. 16 of those 17 are touchdowns. That's efficiency.
16 of 17 touchdowns?
Yeah.
Did you just say that?
Yeah. In the red zone this year.
So we got a very minor quibble. We got one.
Yeah. Something for the coaches to talk about. Second down and goal. Young on the draw. Sidesteps again. Painters, Vince Young.
Take a look at the block by Cedric Benson to the right of your screen. Might not be able to pick it up there, but he had a great lead block, and then Vince Young and his magic legs did the rest, slipping in and out of tackles. That's the old give him the leg, take it away.
That's right. Here it is. Now it's gone.
No, now it's gone, and I'm in the end zone yet again.
Now Dusty Mangamon to attempt the extra point. Once again, he is perfect. Oh, and you talk about great running backs here at the University of Texas. Earl Campbell comes to mind, but so does Ricky Williams. And he's with our Craig Sager now.
Well, you're right, Ron. You can't talk about the stars and tradition without mentioning Ricky Williams' name. Dolphins off this week. What brings you back here?
Well, anytime I get a chance, I have to come back to Austin to where it all began.
You left an indelible mark not only on Texas football, but the entire NCAA. 21 records in the NCAA. When you look back at your career, what stands out?
Well, just the tradition here and the pride here, and coming here every Saturday and playing in front of all these great fans. There's nothing like it in the world.
You followed the Heisman with Earl Campbell. Cedric Benson wants to follow your footsteps. Talk about him and this team this year.
Well, the team is great. They got talent everywhere. I think the best team I've seen Texas have in a very long time. As far as Cedric, you know, he just got to keep on doing what he's doing. He's doing a great job. He had a great offseason, worked really hard, and it shows out on the field.
Well, enjoy your weekend off.
Well, thank you very much.
All right, Craig Sager.
You think he deserved a weekend off, Ricky Williams? Didn't he carry it 40-plus times in a Sunday night game against Buffalo recently?
Yeah.
I mean, he deserves some time off.
He deserves
42 carries. That's unbelievable. 153 yards and a touchdown. He even caught 3 passes last week against Buffalo on the national stage on a Sunday night. He's absolutely incredible. How's this for trivia? How many numbers did he wear here at Texas? How many different jersey numbers?
At least 3 I can think of.
Right? 11, 34, and 37 to honor Doak Walker. What a great young man.
Well, Tulane opts to bring it out. They're going to pay for it. Down at the 13-yard line, a swarm of Texas Longhorn jerseys put Fred Smith to the ground. Now here's how about the first 28 games of Texas, and everybody talks about, well, Cedric Benson isn't doing that well. Look at the numbers, my friends.
Well, wouldn't you say
that if you're not doing that well,
you'd be,
you take it.
You'd be 50 yards behind a guy who won a Heisman.
I mean, I'd take that kind of a bad start. Thank you very much.
But, you know, when Cedric came here, and unfairly as it might be, but Cedric Benson out of Midland Lee High School, great high school powerhouse, was tapped Little Ricky immediately.
And that's almost unfair in terms of comparisons, kind of like when Mickey Mantle came up, making him the next Joe DiMaggio. Speaking of hitting something, huh?
Well, you know, I don't know about you, but Philip Giger put the whap on him. But if I'm Chris Bush, I'm not sending J.P. Lossman a Christmas present. He kind of put him in a vulnerable position on that.
J.P. wanted to get rid of it because he's tired of getting hit in the back. You know, I look down and take a look at J.P. right now. We talked about the hits, and we charted them at the end of the first quarter. And he was 5-for-10 throwing the ball at that time. We talked about Chris Bush being inconsistent. Mm-hmm. Thus far, he's been very consistent, catching everything thrown to him. It's just that Lossman doesn't have much time to set up in the pocket and find an open receiver.
Now they go in an I formation or try to keep it on the ground. Moore, nothing doing. Derek Johnson, that junior linebacker, Butkus Award candidate, and every other candidate you can think of, Nagurski of Lombardi. I tell you, he is very active at 6'4", 230 pounds.
And playing the weak side linebacker gives him a chance to roam a little more free than he would as a strong side guy. A strong side linebacker has to play over the tight end and has to engage him a lot more. This allows Derek Johnson to go sideline to sideline, often unencumbered. But when he arrives, it's a heck of a collision.
You know, you look at that Texas defense, they're bobbing their heads, jumping up and down. They can feel this. They have three on the line. They're showing a blitz. They rush three. Lossman, he is in trouble again, scrambling. Finally throws it, picked off by Derek Johnson. 6th career interception for Johnson, 2nd of the season.
And you can't take credit away from Derek Johnson, but you have to give credit. Watch to the right of your screen. Number 43, Kalen Thorne, knocked down by Kaczynski. The offensive lineman stays with it and flushes Lossman to the sideline. Then Lossman makes an ill-advised pass. And didn't I say Derek Johnson looks like a defensive back? This time he looks like a defensive back and wide receiver, getting both feet down in bounds for his 2nd interception of the year.
One of the Texas DBs thought he had it. Johnson just stepped right in front of him.
I know you had a bead on it, yeah. But I'm here. I'll take it.
Well, Chance Mock back in at quarterback. Benson almost broken. Tripped over the 20 down to the 17-yard line. Brent Quick coming up from that linebacker spot to make the stop.
And if he doesn't make the stop, the cannon's about to fire again.
Golden goalpost.
Because he was gone. And I've talked to a couple of times in this game about the Texas running backs getting to the 2nd and 3rd level of Tulane's defense without being touched. Brant Quick, with his shoestring tackle, saves the day.
Jay Johnson now goes far to the right. Keep it on the ground. Benson bounces to the outside. Gets down to the 15-yard line. First down for the Longhorns. Brandon Spencer on the stop.
See, they're running the ball so well right now that the whole playbook is available to Greg Davis, the offensive coordinator. He wants to run bootleg. He wants to run pass. He wants to run it inside. He can do whatever he wants because of how effective they've been running the ball.
And, you know, we've talked about play callers getting in a rhythm. We talked about it our first couple of weeks on the air. Greg Davis is in a rhythm right now.
He is locked in.
Absolutely.
Because he knows with the running ability that he has, it's going to be 2nd and short on most calls.
10 from the 15. Benson bounces to the outside, keeps his feet, makes it down to the 6-yard line. Here we see the strength of Cedric Benson. You touched on it, the fact that he's 205, best shape ever, trying to show people here's the benefit of it.
Yeah, and he's, again, this offensive line, see Tillman Holloway, 61, engaging. And you look to the side there, number 73 for him, Jonathan Scott, who moved from right tackle to left tackle to provide protection for the backside of the quarterback again. Both of those guys chopped a big hole in the defensive line of Tulane.
2nd down and 2. Ball is on the 7. Longhorns could get a first down. Keep it on the ground. Benson down to about the 3-yard line. It'll be 1st and goal. Trey Boger got his head wrong. You know, think about Benson, though. Just about 55% of his yards comes after contact.
That's impressive. Very impressive. And the tough part for Tulane is that their defensive backs are making so many tackles that it becomes a battle of attrition. Mm-hmm. As the game goes along, you watch it all the time in boxing. If you take the body in the early rounds, the head will die later. Well, they have to make so many hits that by the third and fourth quarter, they don't come up quite as fast to make that hit when you're running into a sledgehammer such as Cedric Benson.
First and goal from the three. Benson in the eye. Give it to the fullback straight ahead. Nope. No signal from the official.
On the carry.
Will Matthews, number 37, had his chance. And he's going to go back and lobby for another one, I'm quite sure.
Wow, Will, you haven't scored this year, partner.
But in this situation, I would not be surprised for him to be the lead blocker for the tailback in Texas to power it in. I called for this earlier, but they threw the ball the last time. Greg Davis, are you listening?
Yeah.
Isolation, run Cedric Benson inside. Make me look good.
Well, Benson is in the eye. Benson, left side, bounces, fighting. Touchdown, Texas.
Thank you, Greg Davis.
There you go.
I got one. Or you throw it up there enough, you eventually get one right. But it was, you know, there's Greg Davis up in the booth. He was a second from your right on the screen. Will Matthews, number 37. By the time he was the lead blocker, there was a decent enough hole that he went through it without having to hit anyone. And Cedric Benson's so strong, he just powered the tackler into the end zone.
Cedric Benson in front of his idol, Ricky Williams.
Out of the hole, Tony Jeffrey.
41-6. The extra point is good. Benson with a touchdown. 3:27 left in the half. The Saddles are being ridden in a Longhorn stampede. Last year, the Longhorns led 14-0 at halftime before winning 49-0. The last four games have been a shutout between these two teams, but tonight they're getting the points early. Stick around for our Chili's halftime report. Ernie Johnson and Brian Bosworth will catch you up on all of today's action, including USC and Southern California. Mangum, by the way, had that last extra point. He's kicking off now. Root and Smith. It'll be Fred Smith on the run. Crosses the 20. Gets another big lick as he gets up to about the 21-yard line. Well, J.P. Lossman has not only had to fight bad field position, but also a lot of pressure.
Carl Reese's defense has come after him from the beginning of the ball game. Ryder Wright knocking one free. Then you see Marcus Tubbs, number 95, collapsing. Kalen Thornton, who's made a couple of big plays chasing J.P. Lossman. So Tim Crowder, number 84, is giving the flush, and another play by Kalen Thornton, number 43. And each time, he's taking a big hit. Brian Rope Robinson with a big play from the linebacker position.
Lossman, a little delayed draw. More nothing doing. May have lost 2 yards on the play with 3:15. Brian Robinson on the stop. Oh, I'll tell you what, that you're not going to be successful.
I mean, even the knockdowns, six of those, three sacks. I mean, he's getting hit almost every time. When we updated it the first time, I think it's 5 for 9, 5 for 10, 103 yards at that point. And then in the second quarter, how about this for numbers? 2 of 8, 11 yards, throwing the ball with an interception. That tells you what the pressure has done tonight to J.P. Lossman.
Well, they've had the big fourth quarter comebacks, but they're in such a big hole now, that's going to have to be a miracle. Lossman, three wide receivers to the right. Again, he has to scramble for his life. Throws incomplete. Craig Seger, you got more on J.P. Lossman?
Well, I've
got to stay in the ballgame because his backup is Nick Cannon, a redshirt freshman who's been in a one play, fumbled, coaches yanked him out and said, okay, had your chance.
Yeah, does that remind you of John Heisman when he was coaching? You know, he made a real declaration, better for you to have never, well, he said, better for you have never been born than to fumble football on my field.
Yes, you got one shot at this. Third down and 11 again for Tulane. Longhorns rush 4, pass overthrown, incomplete. Intended for Tristan Smith. Lossman is a perfectionist. I mean, we talked to him last night and to Coach Selfo and talking about if he's pleased and He's never pleased, even when he throws for 350, 400 yards. This young man just is really hard on himself, and I guarantee he goes in the locker room, he's going to be beating himself up pretty good.
And he's one of those guys that says, hey, I'm here to play football in college, and people go, oh, my God, well, yeah, that's not the student-athlete variety. It's Nathan Vasher brings back this punt.
Vasher, look out. And again, they've got incredible field position down to the Tulane 45-yard line. Now, this Texas Longhorn team is strong, and there's one man responsible for that. And with more on that, here's Aaron Andrews.
Yeah, Ron, and if you don't believe that, you go have the courage and talk to him and ask him about it. You're looking at Jeff Mad Dog Madden. He is the Assistant Athletics Director of Strength and Conditioning. This guy is a motivator, a counselor, and sometimes, if you're not so lucky, a disciplinarian. He was the mastermind behind UT's workout facility. He's worked with 100-plus NFL players. He's trained top athletes like Marion Jones, Mia Hamm. Charles, as you know, this guy's resume is unbelievable.
Yeah, the Mad Dog, thanks, Aaron. That's a great story. The Mad Dog is one of the first guys to turn the strength and conditioning position. And there goes Roy Williams, another one of his proteges.
And he gets inside the 30. You know, and Roy Williams was telling us about that he continues to work on the weights. And, you know, they call Roy Williams a freak of nature. Well, he's a freak of Mad Dog.
Yeah, he came back this year with a purpose to work harder under Mad Dog and get better. But Mad Dog, he was one of the first guys. Boyd Eppley, Nebraska, was the first assistant athletic director for strength and conditioning. Mad Dog was the second, and Mad Dog's the first to rise up to be an associate athletic director for strength and conditioning. And last year, he trained a guy, Mark Henry, a former weightlifter, for the world's toughest man competition, and won that.
We saw Mark Henry the other day in the locker room. Mock over the middle, pass thrown behind and incomplete. Well, intended for B.J. Johnson.
Vince has had one where he missed Roy Williams. Chance right now saying the same thing. I missed B.J. Johnson. Wide open, a ball I need to complete. You see Vince Young on the sideline saying, well, okay, you know, this quarterback thing, you know, I know I'm number two, but things are walking along pretty well, and Chance Mock is the clear number one of this team.
Oh, I don't think there's any question.
And there shouldn't be.
No.
He's earned the job. He's been patient, hung in there, and has the whole playbook absorbed. And these guys, they believe in Chance Mock.
Third in the country in pass efficiency. That's pretty stout. Second down and 10, Mock looking. Plenty of time, throws deep into the flat. Caught, touchdown, Texas. Roy Williams. That's like taking candy from a baby.
Here comes Roy Williams right at you. He hasn't had the opportunities he's wanted tonight because of a couple misconnections with the quarterback. Not that time. And Chance Mock, you know, he was thinking, well, I missed BJ. I better not miss Roy. And it's hard to miss him. And Roy Williams has some of the best hands you're ever going to see. Big but soft. Just envelops the football.
Mangamon for the extra point. Williams' second touchdown catch tonight. And it is good. Next Saturday night, 7 o'clock, we'll make our way up north to the number one in Fair Park in Dallas.
And what we just saw in the highs, we saw Antonio Perkins, number 28. And look at what's happening right here. Explosion plays. Big time for the Texas Longhorns.
They want nine, and they already have 10.
You know, you're already seeing that. But going back, we saw Perkins with the punt return for Oklahoma. He had three last week against UCLA for touchdowns. Mm-hmm. You're wondering why you keep kicking it to him. On the last one, Carl Durrell told his punter, kick it out of bounds. And unfortunately, young man mishit it. And it stayed in bounds, and Perkins brought all the way back. My point is this. Why does Tulane keep kicking the ball to Nathan Vasher? That last punt return by Vasher set them up again in great field position. Chris Selfo told us last night, we're not kicking it to him. I don't know what's changed, but I don't understand why. I mean, he needs to kick it to us every time.
Kick
up
it
here.
Up in the stands. This time it is Smith. He hasn't made it past the 20 yet. We have a penalty flag thrown way back at the 40-yard line. Ross on the tackle. I'll tell you what, if you're even a yard deep in the end zone, sit down. Now you double the penalty and you take it back even further, but at least get some field position.
And Tulane has struggled in recent weeks on special teams. Gave up 189 yards in return yardage to Army. who hasn't beaten anyone yet this year. And Chris Elfo said, Selfo said it's been for two. There's been two reasons why they haven't been good recently on special teams. One has been injuries. They've lost some guys who normally play on special teams, so he's had to fill in with guys who play a lot in the regular rotation. And he thinks that's when they take plays off and they get tired, and that's when you end up with big plays, such as what we've seen tonight from Nathan Basher.
Now you've got to be careful.
You don't want to give up another one here.
No.
You know, you know you need points, but the last thing they need is for that cannon to go off before the half.
Lost with a little toss. Moore tries to find some room, and he's gang tackled at about the 14-yard line. Pickup of two on the play. Derek Johnson had the first hit. Our first and 10 line is brought to you by Home Depot.
Rather appropriate orange here.
That's right.
The burnt orange of the Texas Longhorns.
You finally got that color right.
Yeah, you know, I know I'm a Tennessee guy, and there's always that fight over UT versus UT, which orange. But you know something? I'm in Austin, Texas right now, and this burnt orange looks good.
Now you better say that, my friend.
I do want to be able to travel out.
Partner. Second down and 8. 1:15 to play in the quarter. It has been all Texas from the get-go. Bush in motion. They're just keeping it on the ground. Moore trying to find something. Gets up to about the 17-yard line. Be about a yard short of the first down. Dakari Pearson and Michael Huff combining to make the tackle. And we talk about this Tulane team. Don't get us wrong. This is a pretty good football team. They came in 3-1. First time they're at this mark since they went 12-0 back in 1998. Tulane as a whole program, they're in the midst of some of the most successful football history. And you have to go back something like 64 years to find a team that has won as many as this team has the last 6 years. So this is a good football team.
And Chris Elfo has done a great job as the coach here, putting his program into place. And we just saw Melvin Moore make a tough, tough run that shows that he hasn't given up.
And he hasn't still. Crosses the 25 up to the 27-yard line. Final 20 seconds, or Chris Coleman, the fullback, I should say, on that carry. That should be the last play of the half.
And those are nice runs to see, actually, because we've seen determination in their running. You know, they don't just take the ball and the first guy hits them, they go down.
How about Arkansas beating Alabama? You see the scores at the bottom of your screen. Ernie will have it on the Chili's halftime report in just a couple of minutes. And that's going to do it. Final 3 seconds. Last year, Texas won 49-0. This year, they lead 49-6 at halftime over Chris Selfo and the Green Wave. It has been an almost perfect half on offense and defense for these Texas Longhorns. They came in with some question marks, but a lot of the questions are being answered this evening. Craig Sager with Mack Brown.
Well, Coach, it's one thing to devise a game plan, and it's another thing to have your team execute it to near perfection. 49 points. Talk about the offense first.
Well, Craig, we've had a great first half. The guys came ready to play. The plan's working well for us. We needed to stay on the field and score when we had the ball because Tulane's got some real weapons on offense, which was evident when we blitzed on 3rd and 12, and they took it about 70 yards for a touchdown.
One of the great quarterbacks in college football, J.P. Lossman, hasn't had any time out there at all. What are you guys doing to him?
Well, we've gotten a lot of push up the middle with our four-man rush, so we haven't been forced to blitz, and we can change up our man and zone. And the one time we blitzed him is when he burned us, because he knows where to throw the ball, and he's really quick, and this bunch has come back from behind a lot. So they've been down 31-7 with TCU and had a chance to win 28-14 with Mississippi State. So we can't quit playing. We got to keep playing.
And that's our tease for the second half. Back to you, Ryan.
All right. Thanks a lot, Craig. That concludes the first half of college football on TBS, a part of Big PlayStation Saturday. Halftime score, 49-6. Now let's go to Ernie Johnson and Brian Bosworth back in our studios in Atlanta. Gentlemen.
All right. Thank you, Ryan.
Texas Longhorns dominating Tulane, who has not beaten a ranked team since 1982. 27 straight losses. Right now they trail 49-6, along with Charles Davis. I'm Ron Thulin. At the beginning of the game, Chris Elfo, the coach of Tulane, told our Craig Sager, we have to play the perfect game, and they have not played the perfect half, thus the score.
And when he talked about perfect game, it's not just in turnovers. He's talking about making catches when they have the opportunity, doing the proper things in the run game, not punting the ball to the punt returner who can bring it back for big yardage, all those things. And out of that, not much of it has happened the way that he's wanted.
Well, Tulane will be kicking it off as we get the second half underway, and it's a low squib kick, something they weren't doing in the first half. Fielded at the 14-yard line. Philip Giger on the carry. Let's take a look at some of our halftime stats. And the big one, though, is down at the bottom of the screen.
That was right there. It's explosion plays. 10 for Texas. They come to each game wanting to get 9. An explosion play, any run 12 or more yards, any pass 16 or more yards. And anytime they win the explosion play and turnover battle under Mac Brown, they're 32-0. And right now the turnovers are 2-1 in their favor.
And Texas will take over, first and 10. From the 23, they keep it on the ground. Benson bounces out to the outside. Let's take a look at our Best Buy Authority report. And this is what we've been tracking the entire game, what J.P. Lossman has had to put up with the whole contest.
Yeah, and you know, the sacks are always the thing that everyone wants to take a look at. But for me, it's right here. Knockdowns, right? Knockdowns and also the hits. 14 times he's been pounded besides the 3 sacks. That's led to a 7 of 18 passing, the 1 interception, and he lost a fumble early in the game. We didn't protect the ball on a scramble.
Here we see Lossman on the side. Hopefully he got that ankle retaped. After the pickup of about 7 on the play, second and short for the Longhorns. Mock fakes the pitch, looking deep. Has Roy Williams in the flat. Instead goes to the underneath man. Pass is complete up to the 40-yard line to David Thomas, the tight end. Greg Sager, you talked to Chris Selfo of Tulane. What's the good word? So that's a 100 by 50 vapor lock.
Yeah. If that's what he's telling him.
Oh, boy, I'll tell you what. I've heard some excuses from my kids. That's one of the all-time greats.
Well, I will say this as Tulane continues to fight on the field. I understand what Coach Selfo's saying. He's going to look at the film on Sunday and grade people, and wants them to play as if the scoreboard doesn't matter, because that's how he finds out who the winners are.
That's
on his
right.
Ball club. But that excuse the punter gave, there's only one way to get his attention now.
Put
the backup in.
Put the backup
that's
in.
The best you can come up with. You know, I mean, there's no excuse for that. You can't convince me of that.
Well, punts into the wind are short, not right at one of the leading punt returners in the country.
Never saw an angle.
Never been. Keep it on the ground. Benson bangs his way over the 45. You talk about success. We've been doing football a long time. I can't remember this type of first half success. And on the fumble, Charles, they were driving.
Yeah, they were driving for a touchdown. It was a fumble. It was a mishap between Chance Mock and Cedric Benson. I mean, he tried to slide the ball into the pocket. Don't know whose fault it was. Ball came out. Tulane was able to capitalize and get the turnover. But that only slowed them down for just a little bit, because they came right back with 4 more touchdowns on drives after that. What's the average starting position? Their own 49-yard line.
And this is only their 4th third down attempt. Charles, that tells you something too. Mock 3-step drop, fires it in, incomplete. Pass tipped by Brant Quick, the linebacker, who has played a pretty good game. David Thomas was the intended receiver, and oh my goodness, Texas is going to have to punt.
Is that their punter? Is that Richmond McGee?
Well, I think he's been on the bike warming up.
You know? Let's hope you see him stretching out. See him stretching out to make sure he's loose, because this is his first appearance in the game. But that was nice coverage by Brant Quick. Didn't allow David Thomas's body to shield him off. Was able to get out in front and knock the ball away.
Now, Maweldy Moore standing back. High kick. No wind gets this one. Moore signals the fair catch and has it at about the 7-yard line. 48 yards on the punt. Now the scoring summary looks like this. Chance Mock got the first points, and then Roy Williams on a 13-yard reception, and the floodgates were open, but Tulane made a comeback.
Yeah, Maweldy Moore, after the big pass play between J.P. Lossman and Roydell Williams, he capitalized. And David Thomas slipping out into the flat for a touchdown. Bo Scaife said, one tight end caught one. I need to catch one. And then Vince Young with some great moves, 13-yard touchdown run. And Cedric Benson powering his way into the end zone. And, of course, Chance Mock said, hey, one more. We got to get the All-American the ball again. And Roy Williams takes the last one into the end zone before the half.
And now Maweldy Moore gets up close to the 15-yard line. They'll mark it down at about the 14. Pick up a 6 on the play. You know, it's interesting. Here's Maweldy Moore as Dakari Pearson made the tackle. Maweldy Moore, you know, we mentioned he's part of the San Diego Padres organization. He did not even want to talk about baseball last night. He said, no, I'm playing football, period.
Yeah, you know, he had a bonus with San Diego Padres. They like him as a prospect, but we talked to him yesterday. He said, hey, football's my ticket.
Well, he picked up 6 on that play, 2nd and 4. Moore again looking for a block, cuts back. Gets up to the 15, picks up one on the play with Moore on the Wildy Moore. Here's Aaron Andrews.
Yeah,
that's pretty impressive.
Impressive. He's also on the AFCA, the American Football Coaches Association, Good Works team. You know, got a community service award for business ethics from the School of Business at Tulane.
On third and three, Lossman thrown out in a crowd, almost picked off dangerously close to Dakari Pearson's hands on the interception. Kristen Smith, the intended receiver.
That was almost one where there were too many defensive backs in the same place fighting over the football for Texas. That's a pleasant problem for Carl Reese and Dwayne Aquina, the defensive backs coach, to have. And there's Mac Brown, who he said something interesting, Craig Sager, at the half. But, you know, I don't think he's concerned that Tulane will come back and win, but he's looking at the same thing that Chris Selfo is looking at. Is anyone going to let down in the second half?
Chris Beckman was not even going to let this thing get close. He angled that right towards Coach Selfo on the sideline.
Message received.
Message received, Coach. Well, if you come to Austin, you got to visit one of the many places where some of the great music, including a little blues.
More information.
11:20 to play in the third. Texas leads 49-6. Our first and 10 line is brought to you by Home Depot. Now the Texas Longhorns, the third winningest team in college football the last 3 years behind Miami and Oklahoma. Fourth all-time in victories behind Michigan, Notre Dame, and Nebraska. And they're continuing that tradition of winning this year. Chance Mock leading the way. Williams now in the slot, first and 10. Again, good field position from their own 45-yard line. Mock play action being chased. Still running, throws it away, and he takes a hit as he hits the turf. Anthony Cannon doing a good job running them down. Well, so far tonight, the leaders running the football. How about Cedric Benson? You can see what Chance Mock has done. And Roy Williams, three receptions, a couple of touchdowns, 58 yards. That's a quiet three receptions.
Yeah, but he takes full advantage. If he's only going to get three, puts two of them in the end zone.
Why not?
And Chance Mock, nice play on the sideline again, showing some veteran skills he picked up, even though he hasn't played that much. Only his fourth start, throwing the ball away and avoiding a sack.
Cutback play, Benson shakes and bakes, gets dragged down from behind. Tremel Jack is the one who came up and made the stop from Genereta, Louisiana, the true freshman.
You know Cedric Benson's going to ask in the huddle, how come that broke so big for Brett Robin the two times it ran before?
Really?
Yeah, we ran that nice misdirection, and he broke it for big yardage each time, and this time I get jumped on. What's the deal?
I don't like that, guys. Well, the second half, believe it or not, is when Tulane usually gives up a lot of points. This year, they've given up 25 total points in the first half, and the season 95 in the second half.
Only the fifth third down situation for Texas tonight.
Robin, he gets dumped before he gets up to the 50. May have picked up a yard on the play. Israel Root coming up to make the stop. So Coach Selfo going with a couple of backups and true freshmen, I might add, on defense. Chance Mock can only smile as they're forced to punt. Second, two and out, or three and out for him in here in the second half.
And this is Chris Selfo's way of finding out who wants to play.
Mm-hmm.
You know, you're in the middle of a blowout. Let's play some of the younger kids. It's a great time to get them great game experience in a big time atmosphere, and he wants to see how they're going to react.
James Dunn now standing on his own 10-yard line. Good snap. High spirally kick. Dunn's going to let it go. Oh, my. That's the Charles Davis look up play. Russ just couldn't get a beat on it. Goes into the end zone, and Tulane will take over with 9:42 left in the third. About a mile or so away, the Texas State Capitol, Governor Rick Perry. Of course, Texas in the headline of the news as some people decide to go to New Mexico, and they came back in time for football season. Isn't that amazing?
the tug of Texas football.
Oh, yeah. That
overrides the government every time.
Absolutely. Moore breaks out to the right side, bounces, still on his feet, got the first down, and chalk up a couple more. That is Moeldy Moore's best run of the day. Derek Johnson coming up to make the stop.
Second time tonight we've seen him get to the outside and make people miss. Either he's run through a tackle or he's used a straight arm and continued to get it downfield. That time he ran right through Nathan Vasher, number 3, one of the better corners in the country.
course, he is moving up on the charts on a number of categories. Already the Conference USA career leading rusher is close to, he only needs 2 yards now to become Conference USA's all-time leader in all-purpose yards. Moore is not going to get him on that play. Gets dropped back. We have a couple of penalty flags, probably a face mask back at the 28-yard line. You know, I asked him the other night, I said, listen, you know, you already passed Herschel Walker to number 24 on all-time all-purpose short. Of course, Ricky Williams of the University of Texas is number one. Isn't that amazing? He goes, no. And he wasn't even fazed that he passed a Herschel Walker.
Well, you know how it is with kids nowadays. If it didn't happen just last week, they don't even really know who they are. To him, Herschel Walker, some old guy that played a long time ago.
Personal foul, face mask, the defense. 15-yard penalty from the previous spot, automatic first down.
I mean, think about this. You know, Herschel Walker left college in what, after the 1983 season?
Yeah.
To go in early to the USFL?
20 years ago.
So, right? So,
yeah.
So when you think about it, so 82 and he left, you know, 80, I go, okay, so I guess it was 82 then he left. I mean, this guy, you know, from Weldon Moore, 82.
Yeah, I mean, and at least he knows Ricky Williams.
At least he knows Ricky Williams because Ricky's still playing in the NFL, so he gets to see him every week.
On first and 10, they try to blast it over the left side with Chris Coleman, the fullback, who's primarily a blocker, only had 7 carries coming into tonight. You know, the last couple of seasons, there's only been 3,000-yard rushers in both years. And, of course, we've got two of them right here tonight. Weldon Moore, though, had more rushing yards and receiving yards of any other back. But how about Benson, Anthony Davis of Wisconsin, and, of course, Weldon Moore? That's pretty impressive credentials.
That's outstanding company because Wisconsin constantly churns out 1,000-yard rushers. When you think about the guys they've put out there. You know, Bennett, who's over in the NFL with the Vikings, and, of course, before him, Ron Dayne, the Heisman Trophy winner. Now Anthony Davis carrying out the line, but we've got two of them right here in the same field tonight.
Rossman goes into the flat. Tristan Smith makes the catch close to the 50-yard line. They'll mark it at the 48 of Texas. Giger on the tackle. Pickup of about 5 on the play. Check that 4. You know, I was just going to say, Texas was doing some pretty fancy defense there. That's a pretty good-looking couple of Texas fans. But what they did is they rushed the 3 guys, but then they put it to their linebackers immediately into the flat on that. But they didn't put a lot of pressure on Lossman. That was interesting.
Now, yeah, what they did, rushing 3 and playing zone behind him, 2 linebackers and 5 defensive backs. 3 for 10 tonight on third down conversions.
This is 35. Lossman's getting the blitz from the right side, gets rid of it. Pass is complete. First down to Roydell Williams.
They have a late hit on J.P. Lossman.
Yes, I think you're right. Boy, you know what? And Mack Brown made a great point. We've got to keep playing.
You can't get sloppy now.
No.
See Tristan Smith, number 1, running to the inside.
Roydell
Williams.
Roughing the passer. Defense. The 15-yard penalty added to the end of the run. First down.
And Roydell Williams breaking it out to the outside. Look at the end of the play. Giger coming in and smacking J.P. Lossman after he got rid of the football. You know, when you talk with the coaches, they always talk about J.P. Lossman as our blitz control guy, meaning
that's right.
We always know at least one guy will probably come free. He has to recognize that and know where to go with the football. And he's such a tough guy. You know, no one likes getting hit all the time, but he takes pride in being able to stand in there and deliver the ball, which with all these NFL scouts here tonight, is something that they should be impressed with in watching him stand in there against this heavy rush.
Well, they've had 5 explosive plays tonight. Moore tries the outside, looking for the corner. Strings it out, gets over the 15-yard line, and that's where they're going to mark it. Reed Boyd is the one who forced him over to the sideline. Pickup of about 2 on the play.
Thought that play was going to be over early, but I think number 76, Jimmy Kaczynski, made a great block coming back from the outside in and springing Weldon Moore to let him get to the corner.
And with that, he becomes Conference USA's all-time leader in all-purpose yards. He needed 63. That put him at 64. So congratulations to Weldon Moore. Another record in the book.
Outstanding young man.
Mm-hmm.
As well as a great ball player.
You know, we were talking to him last night. He's walking out of the room. We pat him on the back. We went, ooh, that kid's a rock.
Hurt both of our hands,
yes,
didn't
he? Yes, he did. Lossman, a little touch pass into the end zone. Incomplete off the hand of Chris Bush.
Lossman's pass incomplete. Kicking for number 80, Chris Bush.
freshman Terrell Brown, number five on the coverage. Bush would have made, it would have been a spectacular one-handed catch. Ball was just a little bit long. Chris Bush giving effort and laying out, trying to get to it.
That brings up a third down and eight with 7:15 left in the third quarter. Texas leading 49-6. In case you just joined us, that was our halftime score. Texas opened up a 14-0 lead. Tulane came back to make it 14-6, and it's been all Texas since then. Third down and eight.
Bush is the widest receiver to the bottom of the screen.
And he looks right, goes into the end zone. No, incomplete. It was bobbled. Now the officials are going to check. Let's see.
They've got to confer.
Touchdown, Tulane. Good job by the officials. Roy Dell Williams on the catch.
Got him by formation. Sent three receivers to the wide side of the field. Left Roy Dell Williams in one-on-one battle with Nathan Vasher. And they took their chances with their best receiver. Ball was thrown well. Williams caught it. That's just a touchdown right there. And then ball pops up.
And he
catches
catch it
again.
Absolutely.
See, I think it was a touchdown before the ball popped up.
It was.
All right. See, when he caught it the first time, I think that was immediately a touchdown. So we take a look from the end zone, from our goalpost cam by Allstate. Watch. When he catches it, see right there, I think it's a touchdown. And then the ball popped up, and he caught it again on the rebound. So it continued to be a touchdown.
And he's not out of bounds.
He's not out of bounds. You know, the shoulder might have been in the back, but I think...
I don't think he was.
See, personally, I think it was a touchdown on the first catch before the ball pounced up. It's such a bang-bang play. It's easier to tell in slow motion.
Well, now, Tulane wants to go for two. Let's go to Craig Sager with one of those who are looking at J.P. Lossman tonight.
Well, we mentioned a couple dozen scouts with me, Russ Bollinger from the Detroit Lions. Most of the scouts are up in the press box. You're on the sideline. Why?
Well, it's kind of tough to scout up in the press box, especially when you're looking at a quarterback. And a lot of those guys have already left due to the score. They thought maybe some of the first team guys would leave. So I came down on the floor because I like to look at the quarterback from the sideline. See how he comes off the field after maybe an interception. See how he responds when the score is 49-12. And he's playing hard. He's one of the guys we're looking at. There's 12 seniors on Texas's team we're looking at, and three here on Tulane. So that's quite a few guys to check out on the sideline.
Charles? Yeah, Craig, you know, what they wanted to ask, Russ played in the league and blocked for guys like this. Is this the type of quarterback he would have liked to have blocked for?
You obviously played in the league. You had to block and a lot of great players, a lot of great quarterbacks. What about if you had a blocking assignment to protect J.P. Lossman?
Well, he's a pretty good quarterback. Now, he can run around a little bit, create on his own, and that's a very young offensive lineman that he's playing in front of. So he's had to do a lot of creativity on his own. He's escaped quite a few times. And I'll tell you what, he's a pretty tough kid. He gets hit a lot. I think I would like to play with a guy like that. He's pretty tough.
Don't forget the score. You like what you see?
Like what I see.
All right, thanks a lot, Ryan.
All right, Craig, I tell you, his boss is in Detroit. See, he just did that because he knows he said everybody else left.
Oh, yeah, he made sure.
Yeah, he made sure.
They're gone.
Hey, Steve.
I'm here.
Steve, Coach Mariucci,
hey,
I'm here.
I'm here. And, you know, and that's a tough one for the Lions because, you know, they already have Joey Harrington.
Yeah.
But you know, in that league, you can't have enough good quarterbacks because of the pounding those guys take.
And now Lossman is going for two. Looking left. Eyes the receiver. They've got it. No, they're saying he stepped out. Dropped the ball. Roy Dell Williams had it, bobbled it, dropped it, didn't count. But they do get on the board. Tulane on the touchdown reception. Now full within 49-12.
With the shoulder, I think the way the rule reads is the leg's still in bounds when he made the rebound catch. It was a good play.
There's bodies going everywhere as Texas will again have excellent field position up over the 30 to the 32-yard line. Will Matthews is the one who had the return. And now Vince Young will go back into the game. Vince Young had some pretty good numbers in that first half, including that long run, which covered 60 yards.
And he's back in again with the second team offensive line. You know, they have a real unit going. You know, he's not going in with the first team line and everything else. These are guys he works with every day in practice, and they've been very productive the last two ball games when they've gotten an opportunity to get on the field.
The National High School Player of the Year. This time he pitches back. Brett Robin going nowhere quickly, and he takes a seat back at the 24-yard line. But as you mentioned, Vince Young came in that first.
Another touch, taking another run, this time into the end zone.
Loss of six on that last play. Robin will try it again. This time he takes a hit as he crosses the 25 by Daniel Neville, the senior out of New Orleans, Louisiana. And it'll still be third down for Texas, who have already punted twice here in the second half. And as you saw in our graphic earlier, they didn't punt once in the first half.
If you want to get Coach Mac Brown's blood pressure up a little bit, even though he's up 49-12, have them not pick up this third down here.
That's right.
Because he does not want to see a team come out and just slog around in the second half with a big lead. He still wants to see them be crisp on offense and pursue an attack on defense.
Well, he sees what can happen because he told us the other day that his team became complacent after the big victory over New Mexico. He doesn't want them getting that way again.
And also when you let down, you're more susceptible to injuries.
Young, Roy Williams, up to the 50-yard line. A big-time stiff arm, and he steps out of bounds at the Tulane 48-yard line. Sean Lucas finally got a hold of him. I tell you, you think that Roy Williams is 6'4", every bit of 210, and he uses that.
Well, you know what players say in the locker room? When a guy makes a play like this and he just looks dominant, he's a man.
Yeah.
You know, that's a term you hear all the time. He is a, you know, we always hear like, you dumb man. No, he is a man.
Man, period.
Period.
Yeah.
And when you say that, nothing more needs to be said. That was that type of a play by Roy Williams.
32 touchdowns in 39 games in a Texas uniform. That's a pretty good ratio. Picked up 26, another explosive play for Texas. Young now looking deep in the flat, down the middle. Has a man incomplete. Well, Vince Young is a youngster that couldn't get a hold on the long pass. Roy Williams, on the other hand, is a player that at the end of last year, people thought he would bolt to the NFL, but Roy Williams said, I made a commitment to Mac Brown, and I'm going to stick with it.
Came back, you know, just to hang out another year with my teammates in the city of Austin, and also try to be the best receiver in the country. You know, that's the individual part of it, but the team part is to try to win a national championship, you know, get one more shot at it. Been here for 3 years, so try to score and make it go.
He is arguably the team leader. Robin, left side, got the first down. Gets close to the 30-yard line. Another penalty flag is thrown and might be another face mask. Well, you can see where his helmet is. That's a pretty good sign, isn't it?
Often an indicator the way that it was, the chin strap was popped, but just waiting to get the call, the official word. Yes, and it's a personal foul, so that's a 15-yarder. Means he got his head twisted around pretty well on the grab.
That was a pickup of 16 on a play. Chris Selfo playing a better first half. They did the second half, and he's letting the official know he's not pleased
personal
with that.
Foul, face mask on the defense. It's a 15-yard penalty from the end of the run. First down.
Ernie Johnson, how about an update on the Aggies of Texas A&M and Pitt?
With Pitt's division, I think the South is dominated by Oklahoma, and probably because they're clicking on all three phases, and they've got excellent coaching. And the way their schedule lays out, any team that's going to give them trouble, they get them at home. I think Texas, full of dangerous
at are 4-1, Mark Mangino's guys, after going 2-10 a year ago, and they snap a 15-game conference losing streak today with a 35-14 win over number 23 Missouri. So a nutshell look at the Big 12, courtesy of the new genius in town, the Boz. Back to you guys.
Here to help, guys. I'm just here to shed some light.
Know your role. Ernie, you are the genius, my man.
Hey, thanks, Brian, for breaking it down and giving credit to Kansas today.
Absolutely.
Because that was a game that in preseason people penciled in and said Missouri could very easily come out of the gate 5-0 before they play Nebraska. Mm-hmm. And if we all overlook Kansas, a big win for the Jayhawks and Coach Mangino today.
Well, Brent Robin has stood up right at the 5-yard line, but that is still enough for a first down, and Texas will have first and goal from the 5. Let's take a look at some of the scores from the Big 12 Conference today. Nebraska, of course, on Thursday took care of Southern Miss in Hattiesburg. And as Ernie and Boz talked about, Pitt taking care of A&M today. Texas Tech trailing Ole Miss. That's a big game for the Texas Tech Red Raiders.
Yeah, that's huge for Mike Leach and his team because they have to show they can win one on the road. You know, they're very tough at home. They need to get a big non-conference one, and they're still in that ball game in the third quarter. Iowa State, we saw earlier, lost to Northern Illinois, and we mentioned Kansas and Missouri.
Now first and goal, Benson. Albert Hardy in the backfield. It's Benson right side, and he'll stroll into the end zone. Cedric Benson's second rushing touchdown of the evening.
Most of the first half, I talked about how easy it was for the Texas running backs because they weren't getting touched till they got to the second and third level of Tulane's defense. A linebacker and oftentimes a secondary player would be the first guy to hit a Texas running back. Anthony Cannon, a linebacker, hitting Cedric Benson way too late.
Chris Mangum, or Dusty Mangum, on the extra point attempt. He's been perfect so far tonight. And he stays that way. Now we have a penalty flag thrown on the far side of the field, but the Texas Longhorns with three national championship trophies, all under head coach Darryl Royal. They would like nothing better to add a fourth under Mac Brown. We'll be back.
As low as 3.9% APR all the way to 2005.
And just look at the results. Next time, we give new life to an old closet.
So long, folks!
Yeah, there's something to cheer about with the 80,000-plus here in Austin, Texas tonight under beautiful skies, balmy temperatures, the Longhorns leading 56-12. And, of course, there's the Eye of Texas with Bevo, who's the most sedate Longhorn.
He's actually standing at the moment.
Yes, he is. He's been laying down a lot.
He, you know, usually chills, and he can do pretty much what he wants.
Okay, here's the deal, Bevo. You can either go stand at football games, or you can end up in a grocery store on Monday. What do you want to do?
Hey, he's smart.
I think I'll stand at football games.
For a lot of years, too.
Yes, sir. That's a great job if you got to do it, you know? This will be returned from about the 4-yard line. And again, Texas's kickoff coverage is outstanding. Fred Smith going nowhere. Well, this week's installment of Home Depot Building a Team features players on both teams from the state of Texas. And we talk about how potent high school football is here in Texas. Just look at these numbers. How about that? 71 of 84 and 13 of 60. How about 84 out of 144 players from Texas? Not bad, huh?
Not bad. I think the interesting thing is that at Texas, you know, it wouldn't be unusual if all 84 were from Texas.
That's right.
Yeah, you know, I mean, this state helps stock the top 25 in the country because with the 85 scholarship rule, there are plenty of kids who get away.
Christian Smith looking for some running room, finally brought down by Tim Crowder. Coming up from that right defensive end spot. Not before he picks up some yardage. Well, this Tulane offense hasn't stopped. You got to hand them that after the pickup of 9.
That's kind of been their MO for the season, and with a guy like Chris Selfo leading them, he's going to demand it. I mean, he's not one of those guys going to say, "All right, let's just tuck it in and run the ball a little bit and run the clock and get out of here."
Mm-hmm. That's you know, right.
We still have a Conference USA schedule to play, and we're still in that race. And they say their goal is the Liberty Bowl, and they're not out of that yet.
Austin looks like he may have lost the handle trying to get the first down. Well, you talk about Tulane's schedule, and you know, Coach Selfo told us last night that this is a very tired team. They would have played 5 games in September after tonight. That's a lot. Then they have a bye week, and he says they need that.
Yeah, they need it because let me tell you something. Art Briles' Houston team is playing awfully well. It's a team that wasn't expected to be that good. Bobby Petrino at Louisville, look at the job that he's done. Memphis has improved under Tommy West. And, of course, down the stretch, Southern Mississippi. Playing them is never easy. And you have to go to Hattiesburg to play them.
Yeah.
This Conference USA race will be tight as always. TCU leading the pack.
Third down in less than a yard. Pitch. First down, across the 35, up to the 40, down up to the 45-yard line. Another penalty flag is thrown. That one may come back. Good run, though, by Moelde Moore. Giger on the stop. Well, the officials staying busy tonight.
A lot busier than they would like to be.
Oh, yes. 9 penalties, and this one's going against Tulane.
They keep having to throw the flag, that rotator cuff problem. Well,
there's an older brother, Frank Selfo, on the right. And we asked him, who would, you know, if you guys got in a little tussle, who'd win? He goes, well, I'd whip him every time. And then we asked Chris Selfo. And Chris said, well, I'll say this about Frank. If he doesn't put a lot of points on the board, I'll still love him. I'll miss him, but I'll still love him.
So two ways of handling a dispute. Frank Selfo, who is older by 4 years, you know, said he always used to beat him up and he could still do it. And Chris Selfo said, hold a second, I don't need to fight anymore. I'm the head coach. I can make all the decisions. You know, I'll love him, but I'll miss him.
And you know, they both give credit for their coaching ability to their father, Sam, who was a prep coach for about 29 years, won the Louisiana Class 2A state title with a team that just had 12 players.
Yeah, the Iron Dozen. How about that? Well, family of eight kids are all very close.
All college grad story. Wassman picked off by Johnson again. His second of the game. Looking for Peters. No, knocked out of bounds at the one.
Number
27 yards on the return for Derek Johnson, the junior out of Waco, Texas, a preseason All-American. Second interception of the night.
Watch Derek Johnson working in the middle. I've got the wrong guy ID'd there. No, I don't. That's the right guy. He just worked in the middle and read the eyes of the quarterback and broke. He actually broke to the right first and read the eyes, came back and followed him. Watch him. See his eyes? Just following J.P. Lossman the whole way and broke on the pattern. His second interception of the night, as you mentioned, Parts.
Yep.
And he's a little cranky now because he wanted six.
Oh, he's going to be dogged for not getting in.
He wanted six.
Now Vince Young in at quarterback now. Lossman, two interceptions tonight. Coming into the game, he only had three for the season. They pitch it back. Benson looking for the goal line. No signal. Short. Thought he had another.
Let's see what happened on that play. Is a good sign for Chris Selfo because it's a sudden change play. Team's already down in morale because of the score, but still the defense goes out and doesn't lie down on the first play and just let Cedric Benson walk into the end zone.
Right.
You know, they still stay firm at the point of attack, force Texas to run at least one more play.
Try it again, second and goal. Benson again, bangs inside, waiting for the signal from the officials, still don't have it. Touchdown, Texas. Cedric Benson just keeps adding to the total. Three rushing touchdowns tonight, 86 yards on 18 carries. How about a 4.8 average? That's about what he averaged his freshman year at 4.7 a carry. Well, don't mess with Texas, at least not tonight. David Pino now on for the extra point. The sophomore from Wichita Falls has one tonight. And he has two tonight. What can you say about DJ?
Well, the picture's worth a thousand words. Roderick Wright punches the ball loose. Who's on the spot? Number 11. About this, breaking up a pass attempt to Mwelde Moore. His first interception of the game, that would have been good in the NFL. He got both feet down.
Yeah.
And how about that last one, trying to take it in before he's knocked out inside the 2-yard line. He's active, he's fast, and what he's added to his whole game is a total understanding of the team defense concept.
Let's check in with Craig Sager. Sags.
Well, Cedric Benson,
that's a great point. I don't want him having 100 yards with a sprained ankle and 60 points on the board. That's good.
Yeah, because that'll be a question in the press conference.
Oh,
why was he still, now explain again why he was still in the ball.
And you know, Mac Brown, I listen to his show just about every week. I try just to kind of get a sense of what it's like, and living here in Texas, you do get a good sense. But he said something to me about 3 years ago. He said, you know, Ron, Daryl Royal told me when I took this job that some places you're a football coach 6 months out of the year. In Texas, it's 12 months. 365 days a year.
And no matter what you do, you're going to be criticized.
Right. Israel Root goes down.
And a lot of it, as you mentioned earlier in the broadcast, is unfair.
Yeah.
11-2, 11-2, and this guy has to defend himself all the time.
Every day and every night. You know, when you talk about, you know, what Mac Brown has done to this team, just look at the numbers on the offensive side of the football. I mean, he's been successful at every place he's been. Look at this, 14 500-yard games. I mean, that's pretty stout. He's at 469 tonight. He's about to add one more to that. 14 50-plus point games, added another one tonight.
Unbelievable. And how about this? Per play tonight, almost 8 yards per play, 7.8.
Now we had a penalty on the kickoff. We're going to try it again.
Yeah, I you know, you listen to criticism about coaches, and I know things have changed because of the money in the game, and, you know, it's ramped up with expectations, and the expectations are always high at a school like this. Mm-hmm. But the teams that he loses to, you know, he loses to Oklahoma, who's a national championship contender and wins the Big 12. You know, yeah. And they get on his case about that. Oh, well, you can't win the big one. Right. Well, they went to Kansas State and won. They stopped the streak with Nebraska. Well, it was a 40-something game winning streak at home. Twice they've gone up there and won. You know, you're always talking about, well, what's a big game? Well, a big game is a game that he loses thereby wants him to win.
That's right.
It's just very unfair, I think, to him, what he's done with the program. Do people want to go back to 4-7, which was the record the year before he took over?
The memories are short.
Oh, and I understand it. Everybody wants to see the team win. As he said, if you look at it two ways, it's either negative talk or it's passion. And the only way to survive as a head coach here is to call it passion.
Well, you talk about coaching at Texas. Mac Brown's got it all in perspective when it comes to coaching with the T on the hat. You know, he says when it comes down to it, relationships are what's important. Texas says they're being drawn off sides. He was the fastest coach in UT history to get to 50 wins. That says something when you think of, you know, Coach Bible, who is here, Coach Royal that was here. You look at, you know, Coach Akers and Coach McWilliams. I mean, look at all the coaches that were here, and he was the fastest to get to 50.
And that gets lost because they have not won the Big 12 title, and they haven't won what everyone here ultimately wants, a national title. I just think that people have to remember how difficult it is to win a national title and a conference title in a conference as good as the Big 12. Doesn't mean that they're not trying to get that done.
That's right. You know, and what separates Mac, too, and, you know, we'll end this story right here, but, you know, I was telling about a young man in San Antonio, Texas, a young man by the name of Michael Edwards, who had a very serious head injury 2 weeks ago playing football. And I was telling Coach Brown about this young man. He's in rehabilitation now at Santa Cristo Rosa Hospital in San Antonio, Texas. And he said, you know, I got to write that young man, Ron. Give me his name. I want to write him. That's Mac Brown. He doesn't know this young man. And Michael, by the way, if you're watching, you and your mom, get better quickly, my friend, and I hope your rehab goes well. But that's what kind of guy Mac Brown is.
Yeah, bottom line is he's pure class, and he's an excellent football coach, and people need to recognize that.
Now Lossman now going back to pass, going deep, fighting for position. It's almost picked off by Texas again. Philip Giger right there on the coverage, the junior out of Shreveport, Louisiana. Chris Coleman, the intended receiver.
Now I know they're up 63-12, but Dwayne Aquina, his defensive backs coach, He's gonna make sure Philip Giger remembers this. There may be, you know, a few extra attention getters at practice, because he's gonna say at some point we're going to need that interception, Philip. You know, in a close game,
that's
that
right.
Interception means something. Let's not drop the ones we have an opportunity to get. He did everything right but catch the ball. Now let's finish the play.
Only 149 yards passing the ball tonight for Tulane. They're averaging nearly 340. Wassman. Throws a little look in to Bubba Terranova. He's got some running room, crosses the 30, gets up to about the 34-yard line. That'll be good for a first down. Giger again on the stop. But you can't put all this on Lossman. He hasn't had a whole lot of time to do a whole lot of anything. And we have put three quarters into the books. J.P. Lossman's trying to do his part, but the Texas Longhorn offense and defense, they're running in high gear. They lead it heading to the fourth. As we begin quarter number four, along with Charles Davis, Craig Sager, and Aaron Andrews, I'm Ron Thulin. Welcome you back to Darrell K. Royal, Texas Memorial Stadium, where the Longhorns are commanding 63-12 lead. Moeldy Moore stole the football game for Tulane, and he is tied up by Dakari Pearson. And we welcome you back to college football on TBS, part of Big PlayStation Saturday. One play into quarter number four. The Texas Longhorns lead it 63-12. And it has been an absolutely dominating performance on both sides of the football for the Longhorns tonight. Almost 470 yards offense, 200 yards offense more than this powerful Tulane club.
Now J.P. Lossman searching for that fourth quarter magic that he and the Green Wave have exhibited thus far this season, hoping to get a spark here.
Houdini doesn't have that magic. Copperfield doesn't have that. Listen, can combine them all.
You remember how it ended for Houdini.
Yeah, David Blaine. We'll update a little bit.
Is he still up in that box?
I don't know, but I'm hungry.
Man, 44 days.
third and three.
Well, Nick Cannon, the redshirt freshman out of Pondville, Louisiana. He's warming up on the sideline, and I think Coach Selfo might throw up the white flag here in a little bit.
Well, when you remember what Craig said about Cedric Benson, you know, you don't want him to get 100 yards and a sprained ankle. Yeah. Tulane has a lot of season left, but they only go as far as number seven can take them. So you don't want him getting hurt late in a blowout either.
Rossman completes to Tristan Smith, the junior out of Slidell, Louisiana. He makes the reception. You know, when he has the time, he does throw a good ball.
And you know, he's the kind of guy who throws a good ball a lot of times when he doesn't have the time. But tonight has just been when he's either been rushed or the coverage has been terrific downfield. Mm-hmm. And oftentimes, both.
That's right. It's a combination thereof.
Yeah, and that's a tough one to solve.
First down and 10 for Tulane. 14:02 left to play in the ball game. Ball's on their own 46-yard line. Texas has been alternating a lot of people on defense, trying to keep them fresh tonight. Osman, no pressure, going deep. As a man, and it's going to be picked off. No, dropped. Again in the hands of Dakari Pearson, could not come up with the interception. This telecast is a copyrighted presentation of the University of Texas, a member of the Big 12 Conference. It may not be reproduced or retransmitted in any form, and the accounts and descriptions of this game may not be disseminated without the express written consent of the University of Texas or the Big 12 Conference.
Disseminated. College man.
Don't know what that means. Hey, I know all
but I can read it.
I know all 13 letters of the alphabet. Don't mess with me.
Don't mess with you, big fella.
No, I know. They pitch it back to Mewaldi Moore. Looks for the right side. Talk about smart guys. Darren Andrews is talking about his double majors. How about a guy, a halfback, you say, compare yourself to somebody, and Mewaldi Moore said, well, I compare myself to the character in Romeo and Juliet.
Yeah.
You know, you're going, excuse me? And they played for, what, the Cubs? You got me lost there.
Yeah, you thought Herodotus?
Yeah.
So you thought Socrates was the third baseman, right, for the old Brooklyn Dodgers.
I mean, you know, this is what kind of guy Mewaldi Moore is. He's going to be very successful, not only on the athletic field, but off the field as well. I mean, he grew up in one of the toughest neighborhoods in Baton Rouge, Louisiana. His mom, Sandra, gives her all the credit, says she taught me my work ethic.
Yeah, he also credits his brother Jerry, who played at Louisiana Tech, for his work ethic. He went there and came back and told Mewaldi, this is what it takes to be a college player.
Now Lossman threads the needle inside the 45 down to about the 32-yard line. Aroydell Williams.
It's a big-time throw, wasn't it?
He had to throw that on a rope.
Yeah, that's a big-time throw. I think Chris Selfo is going to enjoy the answers he gets when he watches film on Sunday. No, he's not going to enjoy the loss, but he's going to see a number of guys who continue to compete.
Yeah.
And play well. And Roydell Williams ran an excellent route, and that ball was right there.
20 straight games with a reception for Williams. We want to thank Allstate for providing tonight's goalpost cam. You're in good hands with Allstate. 4 receptions over 100 yards for Williams tonight.
He didn't get to play last year in their game against Texas with a broken ankle.
Rossman barely gets the ball to Moore, and he still keeps his feet moving. Look at him bounce. Oh, my! What a move! Mewaldi Moore inside the 10, 5 touchdown. 32 yards. What an explosion by Moore.
How about that? You know, we can't cheer, right? We're not supposed to root for any teams. But you have to root for this play, don't you? I mean, you got to give this guy big-time credit. What was the score, 63-12?
Yeah.
And he kept going, bouncing off tackles, kept his feet moving, nice spin move, and found the end zone. Great play.
Well, I tell you, that is just upper body strength.
And legs, too.
Oh, he took Cedric Griffin and said, get out of my face, I'm going.
I mean, that was big time right there.
And it looks like Dakari Pearson is the one who may have got the wind knocked out of him, getting up a little shaky. He looks a little on the wobbly side.
Hope he's going to be okay. You know, and the coaches review the films. You remember the long ball a couple plays ago that Dakari knocked down? Looked like he had an interception, wasn't able to come down with it. As coaches will do in film, they'll say, you know something, that touchdown run by Moore doesn't happen if you catch the football. Yes. See, that's how they continue to coach.
That's exactly
in a blowout. You know, they're not going to be very upset with him, but that's how they'll continue to make their point, because you can coach guys when you win big, because you can get on them harder then, because, you know, they're not beaten down so much.
You got to find something to talk about. Barrett Pepper for the extra point, and his second one tonight is blocked. Now the second extra point attempt by Tulane is blocked, and that will get coaches crazy. But Mawelde Moore did a great job with the touchdown run. There is a symbol down here in Austin and also on the campus of the University of Texas, the UT Tower. It's a 27-story main building, and when they win conference championships or whatever, it's bathed in orange lights. It is an impressive sight. You can see it right as you come down I-35. Right now, Ricky Williams talking to Cedric Benson. A couple of pretty good running backs. Cedric went with the hair like Ricky. Is he going to go with that little, whatever that stuff
is?
The little goatee.
Listen, yeah. If that allows you to carry the ball 42 times for 153 yards in an NFL game, wear your hair however you want to.
Now Tulane goes with a little pooch kick, and it'll go out of bounds at about the 25-yard line. Of course, that'll be a penalty flag. Texas has had great field position tonight, and their drives, because of the short field, have been very small. How about their average drive tonight? 5 plays and just 46
yards. Kick out of bounds, places the ball at the 35-yard line, first down.
I mean, when you only have to go 46 yards on your average drive, Charles, you're going to win a lot of football games.
And again, it allows your offensive coordinator to take shots downfield quicker because of field position. It expands the playbook because you're not backed up and having to wedge your way out of trouble. It's been a very comfortable night all in all for Texas. Now, they've created a lot of those opportunities, don't get me wrong, but overall it's been very comfortable for them this evening.
Well, Texas takes over for 10 on 35. We have a penalty flag. And Texas had a little jumping. Got a second. We'd like to thank our hosts here at Texas, Bill Little, John Bianco, one of the great SID staffs in all of college football, for their wonderful hospitality. We do thank you, gentlemen. You're the best. Matt Brown and his staff, thank you, sirs. Donna Turner from
Before
Tulane.
The snap,
thank you.
A contact by the defense in the neutral zone, 5 yards, still first down.
Well, Texas goes with their third quarterback tonight, Matt Nordgren, a sophomore out of Dallas, Texas, Bishop Lynch High School. Matt's another good-looking prospect and another good-sized guy.
Yeah, and people have been terrific to us on both sides tonight, Texas and Tulane, our hosts here in town. And I got to tell you, Ron, I could live here.
You could be mayor.
You know? Matt is a great place.
Matt is 6'5", 220 pounds, and Texas is probably going to empty the benches now. Brett Robin on the carry. Let's check in with Cal and USC. EJ.
What keeps me posted?
Now they have to go for two. Now turn to the third overtime.
Yeah, no, that's right. They have to
now
go,
they have to go
two.
For two. That takes the almost automatic extra point out of it. Although Tulane might beg to differ tonight.
That's right.
Having had two blocked.
Craig Morris on the stop as Brett Robin continues the workhorse effort on his part. What a great story by Brett Robin. We talked about his GPA. He's a pre-med major, and here's a young man that volunteers at hospitals here on a weekly basis in Austin. He went with his dad, as Charles is mentioning, Dr. Sid Robin, on a mission to Africa helping people. Here's a young man. He's married, playing football, but he still finds a lot of time to give back to the community. It's an exceptional young man.
And took his MCAT test for admission to medical school in the middle of two-a-days. Missed a scrimmage in order to take that test.
Unbelievable. Nordgren looking off in the flat. Pass is incomplete. Intended for Brett Robin, the senior out of Austin and Westlake High School, and Texas is going to have to kick it away. Good to see some of the young players, though, that Mac Brown is throwing in here, and they're just reloading down here in Texas.
Yes, they are, and to put a cap on the Brett Robin story, guess when he gets his MCAT results? Next week. So he'll find out what the story is, and I'm betting the news will be pretty darn good for him.
Oh, yeah. I tell you, Mawelde Moore, talk about the workhorse. Now he's back. Is that him back there?
No, I think that's
James Dunn. Dunn's going to take this at the 22, and he's going to sit down at the 22-yard line. Well, we've had a lot of stars on the offensive side of the football tonight, from Chance Mock, Vince Young.
Strength, size, and speed.
And his relatives love him, right, Aaron Andrews?
That's right. I'm here right now with Lloyd Hill. This is Roy Williams' mentor, his big brother, and not a bad mentor to have. This is the all-time leading receiver from Texas Tech. Lloyd, the big story here, Roy decided to come back for his fourth team. I know he asked you for his opinion. What did you tell him?
Well, I pretty much told him that if he wasn't ready mentally, don't come out. Just stay another year and build on that and try to, you know, be the best receiver in the country. And I think he made a good decision on that.
He looks ready now?
Definitely, he's ready. I mean, we get past this season, and he'll definitely be ready.
Now, you weren't too upset that he decided Texas instead of Texas Tech, were you?
No, not at all, because he broke all my records at Odessa Permian. I was just so happy he came to Texas, because I at least want to have a legacy at Texas Tech. You know, if he'd have went there, more likely he would have broke all my records. So, yeah, I'm glad he came to Texas.
Were you worried at all about Roy getting injured this year?
No, because, I mean, I talked to him all during the offseason, and every day after practice, he would run a mile, he would go into the weight room, so I know he was going to be ready physically.
Lloyd, thanks so much. Guys, we're not going to tell you what Roy's real nickname is. Back up to you. Lloyd gave it to us.
What? Hold a second. You can't tease like that.
Don't be doing that to us.
Oh, come on. We got the Roy Dell. Lloyd, come on, Lloyd.
Okay. We got it.
Well, Javon Jackson on the carry. Lloyd just hung us out to dry there, didn't
he? Lloyd, come on, Lloyd. I remember him playing at Texas Tech, too. He was quite a player.
He was a dynamite player.
But he wore number 18. I think Roy wanted to wear that number.
You are good.
And his mother said, Roy, you need to make your own path.
Be your own person.
Be your own person. Your brother's blazed his own trail. You need to do the same thing.
Now Roy Williams can put the baseball cap on and relax. Inside of 9.5 to play in the ballgame. Texas leading 63-18. Javon Jackson stacked up. Nick Cannon in the ball game is Tulane now trying to just make sure nobody gets hurt. Just try to get the clock running. Now this Texas defense has been stout tonight, stopping this high-powered Tulane offense. With more on that, here's Craig Sager. Craig.
Well, Ron, you mentioned you don't want to get anybody hurt. We need to mention that the two strong safeties, the two starting safeties for Texas, both injured in this game. We saw Dakari Pearson just go out. He has a left shoulder injury. He is in the locker room right now getting x-rayed, also looked at. And earlier in the game, in the second half, Michael Huff went down with a sprained left ankle. They had taped that up. It didn't work. Iced down. He also was undergoing x-rays. So there are two safeties, both injured in this game.
Well, you don't want to see that, because as we mentioned, their next couple of games, Texas's next couple of games, they're brutal. Not only do they have Kansas State coming here, and Bill Snyder had the week off, L. Roberson is expected to play next week, and he's got a dynamite defense. Then you got to turn right around, and then you got to play Oklahoma on the 11th, and then don't forget Nebraska on the 15th, or on November 1st.
Look at those back-to-back.
And the last three aren't going to be that easy.
Yeah, the last three. I mean, look at the last four. Look at that. Nebraska, Oklahoma State, Texas Tech, and, of course, the traditional battle with A&M. And remember, you know, something we haven't talked about today. Texas's safeties are really corners.
That's right.
I mean, they're not safeties in the traditional sense. They play with four corners. Look at that speed on the corner.
And the ball is loose, still on the turf. See if Tulane's regained control. They're going to have a little scrum for this one.
Wow.
Texas has it.
That was number six, I believe, Mike Williams, the defensive end who's just returned from injury, coming around the corner. I mean, you don't see too many defensive ends in a single-digit number. You know, it's almost like an extra defensive back coming at you from a down position. And here's the scramble. And you never know how many times the ball changes hands at the bottom of a pile.
But you got to love
it. The big guy won that one. Look at Marco Martin, number 94.
Who has the best nickname on this Texas team,
Big Yummy. Is that Big Yummy?
Big Yummy. You got to love Big. I thought Booger McFarland was pretty good in the old SEC, you know? But a Big Yummy's pretty good.
Big Yummy trumps that one.
Big Yummy's got that one.
Well, he certainly treated going after the ball as if it were a treat, didn't he?
Yeah, I tell you, you know, this is a young man, a redshirt freshman out of Mesquite, Texas, outside of Dallas. They call him unblockable. And he's going to be another one they're going to reload with.
And Mike Williams coming around the corner forced the fumble, number six, and they're happy to have him back. But, you know, finishing up that point about the corners, the safeties. Four corners because they like having the speed, but sometimes you get hurt in a run game with bigger, deep, bigger attacks. But the good thing Texas has, they have four guys who will strike you.
Anthony like Johnson that. Like that. That's right. Anthony Johnson, the sophomore out of Jefferson, Texas. Johnson lowers the boom on him. Kelvin Johnson, the true freshman out of Florida City, Florida.
You know, when you're running these kind of ISO and trap plays, you count on your fullback to take on the first linebacker in the hole. But as he shifted to his left, Kelvin Johnson had a wide open shot, and he won the battle.
That's a denture check there, isn't it? You make sure all those bicuspids are in order.
Yeah, one of the few times in your life you're actually okay with going to the dentist.
That's right. Matt Nordgren in at quarterback. We've already seen Chance mock Vince Young. Third down, we'll call it five. Down to the 24-yard line is Anthony Johnson. Fans, for exclusive news and recruiting coverage of your favorite teams, log on now to Rivals.com. Oh, I tell you what, coaches are out recruiting now, and now's the time to start checking things out. We're getting verbal commitments as Chance Maku did his job on the sideline. I tell you, you know, when we met him yesterday, we look at the numbers, and we're always a little skeptical when they say how big a guy is. He was bigger than I thought he was,
yes.
And watching him in practice Thursday, his arm is much stronger than I think we all had this idea of.
Yeah, he's filled out well, hasn't he?
Yes, he has.
He has the good genes. His father, a former linebacker in the NFL.
He's finally lettered, too.
We were laughing about that, weren't we?
Finally lettered. They keep it on the ground, rumbling inside the 20 down to the 15-yard line. Ivan Williams, the running back, back into the lineup. Here's a young man that showed a great deal of promise, trying to do a little Warren Sapp dance there. Ivan Williams has been injured, but this is a young man that came in just as hyped as Cedric Benson was when he came to Texas.
And grew into a fullback position, was playing as well as any fullback they've had in recent years before he was hurt. And now he's battling his way back, and this is his first appearance on the field this year. And that was the great ovation he received from the crowd. Happy to have him back.
How about Marcus Tubbs giving him an attaboy walking off the field? 5:35 to play. Keep it on the ground in the fullback position.
This time,
Eric Hall on the carry. Our first and 10 line is brought to you by Home Depot. It's something that the University of Texas has crossed a lot of times tonight. How about 25 first downs over that first and 10 line by Home Depot?
Second and 7 from the 11.
That's Mac McWhorter, the offensive line coach, who's receiving a lot of credit for making this team a much more physical inside running team with the power blocking that he provides, that he stresses. Of course, the 6 o'clock team meetings.
That's right, that'll help. Oh, my.
6 a.m.
That's right. Eric Hall just tripped. I think the 9-yard line reached up and tripped him.
I think the Home Depot line got him.
I think it did.
I think
Eric
the orange line jumped up and got him.
No, big Eric saw pay dirt. He was thinking, I'm going to get my name in the paper. And his legs were moving a little too fast.
He's got a nice hole. Working again behind the second string offensive line for Texas. Maybe even gone down to some third team guys. And he was trying to get a straight arm set as he saw Winfred Brown coming after him. See how upset he was. Like, if I only kept my balance, I could have taken that guy on.
From Clarksville, Tennessee, 245 pounds he's listed. Well, he looks a little bit bigger than that.
If he's the last train to Clarksville, that's a pretty good ride, isn't it?
Thank you, Mr. Dolans.
Thank you. Thank you very much. And there's a penalty. I think the clock may have run out on him. Got delay of game.
I think it is.
Or illegal participation.
Delay of game. The offense. 5-yard penalty. Still third down.
3:59 to play in this game. All Texas at 63-18. Chalk up another one on their record. Coming up, the Schick Quattro postgame report. Ernie Johnson, Brian Bosworth will catch you up on all of today's action. Of course, they've been updating you on USC and Cal. They'll have that. Arkansas, Alabama, they'll have that. And all the upsets in college football today. Iowa, Michigan State, how about that?
How about Washington State jumping out of Oregon?
Mm-hmm. Mike Bellotti was feeling real good coming into the day.
Yeah, he was scared to death after the win with Michigan, and the guy spent a whole week. Everybody tell him how great they are. You beat a team that people pick for the national title.
Yep.
Oh, Washington State coming to our place, we can handle them. Well, Bill Doba is doing a great job.
He really is.
Up at the Palouse. I mean, he's doing a fantastic job. They should have won at Notre Dame.
Mm-hmm.
You know, they should be undefeated right now. And they've got some pretty good pelts in their pocket, don't they?
Yes, they
Colorado,
do.
Right, went to Colorado and won. Went to Oregon and won already. They're going to be a tough out in the Pac-10 also.
Well, fourth down and 3, Mac Brown, instead of kicking the field goal, and actually this is a good move. They just don't want to put any more points on the board. We just want to get their guys some reps here. Fourth down and 3. They give it to the fullback. Bouncing straight ahead inside the 5 down to the 3-yard line, and that should be a first down. Albert Hardy. Let's go back to our studios in Atlanta with an update on Cal. I don't think there's been bedlam in Berkeley like that since Clinton defeated Bush in the presidential election.
The offense. 5-yard penalty. Still first down.
I thought more in the 60s. Wow. Hey, okay, let's go ahead and talk about that briefly. Did you see that one coming?
A lot of people did, believe it or not.
Did you see it coming?
Did I see it coming? No.
Because I didn't see it coming.
No, because I thought Pete Carroll, I'm a big fan. I picked him as the national champion this year. Did not see it coming.
I did not see that one coming.
No.
Great job by Jeff Tedford and the Cal Bears.
Absolutely.
It's a fantastic job.
George Cortez, great offensive coordinator up there. Did a good job.
How about them hanging in there and slugging it out through overtime with a bigger, stronger USC team? That's a huge move.
Now, as we go close to 2 minutes, there was a penalty on that first down run by Hardy, so they brought it back. Hall tried it again. That brings up a second down and goal, and it's at about the 7-yard line.
Hope springs eternal again in the Pac-10. After the way USC started, people were saying, well, it's USC
over.
And Chase.
Yeah.
But guess what? We're still early in the season. They already have a conference loss. Arizona State, despite their loss at Iowa, they don't have a conference loss yet.
No,
they're
don't.
One of the top teams that's been picked. Washington won today over Stanford. Oregon's lost to Washington State. How about Wazoo? That's going to be a heck of a deal.
85 scholarships catching up to a lot of teams.
Yeah, it's not just the non-BCS conferences, is it?
Right side, Hall carries, bullies his way inside the 5, down to about the 3-yard line with 1:23 to play.
29.
And we close into 1:15 to play. Chris Selfo's team just outmanned tonight. They got hit. They got bushwhacked on every stage of this football game, and they just got to go back, take the week off, regroup, put some new defenses in there, and get ready for Conference USA season.
Yeah, they've made some nice comebacks this season, but none against a team that's as good as this Texas team, although TCU is awfully good themselves.
Not the caliber of this team. Now the fans are booing because they want Texas to go for it, and Mac Brown's doing the right thing. Of course, he was former athletic director and head coach at Tulane, and he didn't want to run it up on a program that he was part of.
You know, I don't think Mac Brown would run it up on his worst enemy.
Not a bit.
You know, it's just not his makeup. You know, as he told us yesterday.
Third penalty, still third down.
You know, he's kind of like there's a right way to do things and a wrong way to do things in his opinion, and he's always going to try to follow the path the right way. Fans will be upset, but hey, you know.
he's the one that's got to look himself
he's
in the mirror tomorrow morning.
At it.
So it's third down and goal now from the 8, 27 seconds left, and this will probably be the last play of this football game. Long snap count. Going around the right side, and that might do it.
Ball carrier number 9, Anthony Johnson.
Anthony Johnson got inside the 5, and that's going to do it. Chris Selfo's team came here with high expectations, said he liked some of his matchups, but Mac Brown and company came in like a whirlwind from the get-go and scored on every possession but one in that opening half. And Charles, that was about the most complete game they have played this year, hands down.
And they really got it together in the second half after a slow start and played as Mac Brown wanted them to play. You're right, the word was complete, and that's what they had today.
And Texas wins it 63-18 over Tulane. We'll step aside and come back to Darrell K. Royal, Texas Memorial Stadium right after this. The Home Depot. Go from wondering how to knowing how. At the Home Depot, you can do it. We can help. Hampton Inn, we love having you here. Chili's, spicy, boneless, cool. Chili's, boneless buffalo wings. And PlayStation 2. Texas wins it in impressive fashion. Quick comment about Texas, Charles.
You mentioned it, a complete game by the Texas Longhorns. I'm anxious to see how they bounce back from this one and get ready for Kansas State and then Oklahoma in 2 weeks.
Next game will be next Saturday night, 7:00 Eastern. Number 1 ranked Oklahoma takes on Iowa State. For Charles Davis, Craig Sager, Aaron Andrews, and the rest of the crew, I'm Ron Thulin saying good night from Austin. After this break, it's the Schick Quattro postgame report with Ernie Johnson and Brian Bosworth.